before, please, Lindsay. Lindsay?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey, could have done a drive off there, you know.
That would have been on the video. That's £22, please.
Yeah, sure. Hey, listen, how's your dad?
So-so.
Yeah, well, he's been in long enough, hasn't he?
Yeah, well, he's been ill, hasn't he?
Sorry, yeah. Just ask him, no?
He said he can come home when he's feeling better.
Yeah, I'll give him my regards, eh? See ya.
See ya,
Jack.
See you,
love. What was that about?
Nothing.
Who are you kidding?
I'm just daddy enough, that's all.
Fine. Just don't be snappy to customers.
I should have slapped Shelley, you know.
Violence won't get you anyway. Listen, is there any chance he's swapping shifts with me?
When?
Well, now I've got to do something.
Well, I was going to go and see my dad. What have you got to go and do?
I just want to see the doctor.
Is everything all right?
Yeah, just a bit of baggy.
Oh, why don't you just nip into the drop-in?
Oh, wait.
Maybe I should go over there. See if they can give me something to take my mind off her.
Lindsay, just forget Shelley.
I can't, Mum. But I keep trying. I just can't.
You want to see what I've got, my days? It cost an absolute arm and leg.
Nice.
Hey, do you think he's going to like me in this?
Oh, I quite like that myself.
Hey, you. Keep your fantasies for the new woman in your life.
Oh, I wish.
So, are you bringing her here for Christmas dinner?
Oh, unfortunately not, no.
Oh, right, you're going to wear then?
No. Me and my Mrs. X won't be seeing each other at all over Christmas.
Oh, do you want me to have a word? I will.
I don't think that'd be very wise, Beth.
Look, Shell, you me mate, right? And I'm going to feel awful giving my Dave gifts galore and he's throwing the lips on me and you're sitting there shedding buckets because you can't get to grips with your new bit of pash.
I'll deal with it, Beth.
Look, let me have a word with it, please. I'll bring her round, hey, and I promise my lips will be stapled on this one.
Look, I'm sorry, I can't. It would kill her. Bye.
Right. That's it, I think. Now then. Oh, beautiful, isn't she? Well, it's a very special day today. Mummy's coming home.
No fault?
Library?
College?
Nope.
Uncle?
I've got an essay.
All right. On what?
On gender.
Oh, you mean like men and women and that?
Yeah. You know, the way men take advantage of women and that.
All right, Jay.
Hit the sore point, have I?
How long's this gonna go on for?
You stepped over a line.
We're not talking about two kids here.
I know, we're talking about my mother and she was vulnerable.
Well, so was I. Well, no one got hurt.
But you slept together, Mick, it's not on.
If you're a 10-year-old kid, I could understand where you're coming from.
Well, have you called her since? Have you even seen her?
Things like that don't happen anymore, Jay.
So you just slept together and that's it, finished? Where's your morals, Mick? And I mean the pair of yous. I'll go in the library.
No wonder I feel sick.
That's normal.
It can't be. Nearly vomited before.
Well, you haven't got a temp, love.
It could be meningitis. A type that you haven't heard of before.
It isn't meningitis.
Do the glasses on my arm again.
There's still no rash. You haven't got a temperature. And no stiff neck.
Well, it was hurting me before when I come down the stairs.
Look, you're just having an off day.
It could be, mastitis.
You have not got inflamed breasts. Listen, you're probably just upset because I didn't see your performance last night.
It's got nothing to do with it. I'm sick. I might die.
Right. Well, it'll be a couple of hours or so.
Going Christmas shopping?
No, actually, we're bringing Susanna home today.
Home?
Yes. In the coffin.
Oh, right.
Which is why I want the children out of the way while she arrives.
Won't they feel a bit scared when they see you?
Scared? Not at all. Bye-bye, you two.
I wonder if you'd give us a hand looking after Josh once he breaks up. Yeah, but it'll be the last time. He's getting a bit old.
Fair enough.
You after him or something?
No.
He's leaving the kid there while he goes and brings Susanna's body home.
Oh, I couldn't do that.
I'd be terrified.
Oh, well, let's hope it's a closed coffin, eh?
She's been dead a while.
All right, Funny.
Hiya.
I'll just do the tree.
Secret one, is it, then?
You what?
Aren't I allowed to see it?
All right, yeah, of course. Sorry, come on.
All right.
Like the music?
Yeah, just revisiting a bit of my past, you know, the good old 70s.
Did you have an afro?
Ain't the biggest. do you like a drink?
Please.
Hi, Dad.
Oh, straight from work.
Yeah. Prezzy.
Oh.
How you doing?
Oh, yeah, not bad, fine.
Good.
Didn't know they still made that. How's your mum?
It's okay.
Has she forgiven me for giving her that minty card yet?
Of course she has.
She had a right weird on.
Well, she's got things on her mind.
Like what?
Oh, just, you know, work and that.
Lindsay, I might be stuffed full of antidepressants, but I know when you're stringing me along. It's me. I know it is.
What's you?
All this, being here. Trying to talk myself.
I thought you said that was all my mum's fault.
It was projection.
What?
No, projection. It's sort of putting your feelings on someone else, you know, because it's better to do that than face up to the truth.
And what is the truth?
Well, early on in my treatment, I did think it was all your mother's fault, you know, me. Being here. All that. But I've been hiding, love. Hiding from the reality that I'm weak.
Dad.
No, love, this is important. They've taken me through all my life. Sharon? Oh, she's one of the nurses, she's nice. She's helping me with the psychologist. Spilt it all to them. Oh, Frankie. Billy. The bullying when I was a kid, being the younger brother. And blaming them for the way I carried on nicking stuff. And then when they were out of the way, blaming your mother. For the drink, drugs. Anything but look at myself. I'm crap at making the right choice, Lins.
At least now you know it all, you can do something about it, can't you?
Well, I hope so.
How are you, darling?
What's you in here?
The one and only. So when did all this start?
Dunno.
I'll be upstairs if you want me.
She doesn't care about me no more.
She loves you like mad.
She fell asleep in me play. She wouldn't have done that before she was having this baby.
Women always get tired when they're expecting a little one.
Why?
Because the dear thing needs loads and loads of energy to grow and it has to get it from your mum.
Oh, so it's the baby's fault that she fell asleep?
Well, it doesn't work quite like that.
Well, she's just going to get more and more tired, isn't she?
Yes, but...
And I bet she wouldn't have fallen asleep if I was a real son.
Oh, don't be thinking like that, love.
That's true. All she wants is her own baby. Then we'll get binned off.
More coffee?
No, thanks. Listen, I know last time we were together things weren't A1, but...
I was all over the place, you know, finding out about Susanna.
And I understand that. But was that closing the door on anything between us?
Well, no, you know, but sometimes these things are best left alone until they kind of, well, happen naturally, you know.
Well, in my experience, they usually need working out, unless there's nothing really there.
Well, the thing is, I do like you and all that, but...
Hold on. Don't patronise me with playground chat.
No, I'm not. Look, Funny, you...
And don't call me Vonnie. Only Frank called me that. To you and everyone else, it's Yvonne.
OK. Maybe I just don't want to get into anything serious.
I'm not after serious. But I am after being treated with a tiny bit of respect.
I can see I'm wasting my time here.
Bye.
Hiya, love. I'm just going.
What's going on?
Nothing.
Mum, wait! What have you done to her now?
Everything's just the way you want it. There's nothing going on between me and your mum. Now, whatever.
Just some bits for the Christmas party.
They're on offer.
All right, I will get another one. My Dave loves them.
Jimmy used to, but he's gone off them now.
Oh, medication, is it, yeah?
What?
Well, I remember seeing it on One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. Some bloke was talking about how they give you something that stops your sex drive, so I suppose it might put you off your grub and all.
Yeah.
There you go. How's Lindsay?
Oh, you know.
I don't think Shelley meant to hurt her, you know, but I think she was just swept away by this new woman. She absolutely head over heels.
Is that what she said?
Well, not in so many words, but living with a lesbian, it gives you a great insight into the way they think. Anyway, tell you one thing, Shelley is certainly keeping mum about who this other woman is. But don't worry, I'll get out of her. I'll keep you posted. Tra!
Did you know he was bringing the body home?
No.
Didn't seem too keen on it when I talked to him.
He's obviously changed his mind. Poor fella must be beside himself.
So when's the funeral?
Not sure.
Hey, is she in there?
Yes, now in you go. You're not well, remember? Has he got the kids there?
I don't know.
What, is his front room big enough to get the pram in and out around the coffin?
Mum, how should I know?
Coffee.
No sugar?
No.
So, when are you coming home?
I was nearly on my way. Till I mentioned Van Gogh.
The painter?
One of the inmates. I shouldn't really use that word. One of the other fellas, you know, I mentioned how Van Gogh had lobbed off his ear. And I was saying I thought that was a good idea, you know, topping yourself when things got a bit grim.
Oh, Dad.
Only Sharon thought it was an inappropriate response. And we had to do half an hour on what I meant.
And what did you mean?
Well, I don't know. I sort of identified with what he was on about.
Is it in there?
Oh, yeah, I make notes. Yeah. So he said he wanted to be what you called alone with nature. And there's been loads of times in my life when I've wanted to be alone, you know, or felt alone. And he cut off his ear because he was having problems with this other painter. And Sharon, well, she thinks that maybe, you know, me drinking or, you know, taking drugs and that is a response to me problems with me family or your mother or whatever.
Well, that's good, Dad, you know, that you're working out your problems and trying to deal with them.
Yeah, but I'm scared, look.
What of?
Well, that I won't ever get over the loneliness I feel, you know. Deep down inside here. And I mean, Van Gogh shot himself. And look what he'd achieved with his life. I'm 50 next year. What have I got to show for it? Nothing.
Hi.
Hiya, Max. I saw the coffin coming before and I thought, you know, last respect to him.
Come in. She really loved this music.
I didn't realize you were bringing the body, bringing her home.
It's what she wants. So how are you feeling? You seemed a bit angry the other day.
Ah, you know, starting to accept things. Wish I could have finished it on a better note, but, well, I've kind of forgiven her.
That's good. She knows you've forgiven her.
Didn't want this to happen to her, though, Max. She was really special.
She knows you loved her. She's sorry.
When's the funeral?
I'm waiting for them to contact me.
You let me know, eh?
Oh, sure.
All right, I'll go.
I wish you'd have let me just have a word with the staff.
You don't need to. Everything's all right.
Yeah, but what about the book? I mean, jotting things down on that.
No, they encourage you. Keep a record of our feelings. It's okay.
Jimmy!
All right, Kenny. I can feel myself getting stronger, love. Hey, when I get out of here, you won't know me. I'll make it up to you. And Kylie. And our little Wills. And even if I have to go down on my hands and knees and beg your mum's forgiveness, I'll do it.
You won't have to do that.
Gonna see a new me, Linz.
Liam, love, look after the place for us.
Yeah, sure.
I've just got to go on a little message.
Where's the invalid?
Bathroom.
Oh, this time next year, you'll be writing the baby's name in those cards.
I can't wait.
Have you thought of any names yet?
We haven't really talked about it much.
Well, you must have thought of some.
Erin, Zoe.
Erin Murray, that's nice. What about Kim? You were nearly Kim.
Was I?
Your dad had an eye for Kim Novak, but I was young and jealous at the time, so I said no. Kim Murray, that's nice. And if it's a boy?
I thought Niall, Gavin or Russell.
You can't have any of those.
Why not?
Saint Ollie, Saint Gavin.
You don't have to have saints' names.
We do. We're Catholics.
We are, love.
Hiya.
Any chance of a favour?
Sure.
Hiya, Miss McKenna. Max has to bring the kids over, but...
But what?
He's brought it on his body home, and I don't really want to go in there on my own.
We'll take them in for you.
I was only going to ask Di to come over, that's all.
I'll come and bless the body.
On that couch, now.
I know it sounds childish, but they brought me Jason's dad's body home in a coffin, and I just got a bit nervous.
I'll get me coats.
I know. You stop here and look after Anthony, and I'll go over with Di.
Are you sure?
Positive. I've had loads of experience with this sort of thing.
Ta.
You can see if the pram fits around the coffin.
I'm just being neighbourly.
Coffee?
Don't think I'll be staying that long. You're not here on a social visit, then?
No.
Can we sit and talk?
You know, calmly.
I don't want to, sis. But I would like to know what you've been telling our Lindsay.
About what?
About the fact that you're in love with this other woman.
Well, that's hardly news to you.
I don't want you saying this again, do you?
I said it because I meant it.
I want you to stop hinting to her that there's any chance of you and this other woman getting together. Lindsay's in bits.
And you don't think I am? Have you any idea what I'm going through?
Please, will you stop it? I'm old enough to be your mother, for God's sake.
What's that got to do with it?
I'm supposed to be thinking about grandchildren and coming to terms with my life, not getting involved in all this sort of thing with a woman.
See? You have no vanity. There's no side to you. That's what I find so attractive.
Will you please stop saying these things?
Oh, you know, thanks for bringing them over.
Oh, Katrina was very busy, so we were only too happy to help out. Weren't we, Mum? Weren't we?
Oh, yes. I didn't think you were bringing her home.
Well, you know, I thought about what you said, and, well, it seemed to make sense.
Lovely coffin.
Thanks.
Is it oak?
Yes.
Did you go for the veneer or solid?
Solid.
Classy. I wanted a solid mahogany for my mother, God rest her soul, but we hadn't put enough away. So I settled on a light oak veneer. to the line of plastic handles, though.
Oh, my sentiments entirely.
Right. If there's anything we can do to help.
Thanks. Oh, and thanks again.
Any date for the funeral yet?
Well, you know that the undertaker hasn't given a date yet.
The sooner the better, eh, love? Then you can move on.
Hey, you asked me to say what attracted me to you. And none of that's changed. I'm still just as passionate. That's enough.
No, I still love you, and I know that deep inside that the night we shared was open and honest, and you love me back, Jackie. You just can't bear to think that you gave yourself to me.
Shut up! You are one spiteful, perverted little bitch!
Here we are. You and me and Harry and Emma. A family. You're back where you should be. At home. Forever.
You look happy.
Just been to see me, Dad.
Oh, is it?
I wish none of us had ever set eyes on you.
Why do you keep pointing the finger at me in all this?
Because if you hadn't have been around, none of this would have happened.
Oh, so I'm to blame. The predatory dyke casts a spell.
Don't mock me.
No, I'm just trying to get you to see that you had a part in all of this, and so did Lindsay. I never forced anyone into anything.
That's not the way I see it.
So why don't we get Lindsay up here and see if she feels the same way you do?
Don't even think about it.
No, then we can see who the real victims are.
What are you talking about?
I'm trying to protect you both in this, because, you know, you and Lindsay have got to stay a family, but, you know, I'm fed up of being painted as the villain.
If the cap fits.
You knew exactly what you were doing when you slept with me. And by my estimations, you enjoyed it.
You look after yourself, okay?
What's going on?
Get a pair of this!
No, I'm not! Just put it
down! Help me!
Put it down!
Get off!
My Tyson this morning, then.
Bev.
You remember that car from the pool party? The Madeline agent? Who wants to see me? I've been on to the undertakers again, and they say you still haven't made arrangements for the funeral.
Would you like a cup of tea?
No, thank you. I want to know why you haven't buried my sister yet.
Yeah, Mum. A woman of your age is disgusting.
That hour-long Brookside means that for this week only, Poisoned is on Friday at 8. Next up tonight, two gangs, both scary, and they both want representation. No room for mistakes in the courtroom in North Square.
Finish that, Harry. Hey? Good boy. Well, Daddy will have to do his when he gets back, won't he? Hey? Right. Off to play school. Now then. Where did I put your shoes, Harry? Oh, dear. Silly Daddy keeps losing everything, doesn't he? Hey?
Silly.
Oh! Oh, hey!
I still can't believe you'd do that to me.
I'm sorry, and I meant it.
Yeah, Mum. Woman of your age, it's disgusting.
I know.
What would have happened if we hadn't come and found you when we did, eh?
fighting like a couple of kids.
So you still haven't put that up? You've been doing it since this morning.
Yeah, well, it's not easy to get it straight on your own.
Yeah, well, don't expect any help from me.
So,
how's Mike Tyson this morning, then?
Bev, I'm so ashamed. You've got to let me pay for everything that I damaged.
That vase was priceless she broke, wasn't it, Bev?
Well...
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Hey, it's friendship that's priceless. And I'm minted, so that's the last I want to hear of it. Anyway, to see Jackie Corkill rolling about in the carpet with me lesbian flatmate, it was almost worth it. Mm. So, what's it all about, then?
It's nothing, really.
Oh, come off it. You're practically having sex when we walked in.
Bev, we were scratching each other's eyes out.
It's not what it looked like to me.
Well, I can assure you that's all it was.
I'm only teasing.
Pour it in a bag, that'll do. Remove from box, place unopened bag into a saucepan of boiling water. Right.
Right then. I haven't heard a squeak out of any of you for weeks, and suddenly there's a big rush on. Could it be the thought of a big fat Christmas scoff, I wonder?
I am going to stuff myself all the way to New Year's Eve.
Good on you, Beth.
Right, has anyone brought the food diaries, or have you all burnt them in shame?
I've got mine.
Yeah, me too.
We've all brought them.
Let's have a peep at them, shall we?
You know, suddenly I could just eat a whole tray of donuts.
Is everything OK? You sound a bit weird on the phone.
Yeah, great. I've just had some good news, that's all. I just couldn't wait to tell you.
All right, great.
You remember that Carl from the pool party?
Carl?
The modelling agent.
I know what you mean.
Well, he wants to see me. I mean, I think he's going to give me some work.
Right.
It's a really good opportunity. It could lead on to big things.
Go for it.
He wants to see me tonight.
Oh, I see. So you won't be coming round then?
I can come round tomorrow night instead. What's the matter?
Look, it's just... I seen this documentary about guys like him.
And?
Well, they weren't all they cracked up to be. I mean, some of them were dangerous.
You're worried about me? Oh, that's so sweet. Carl is just not like that at all. I'm really careful about things like that. Especially after what happened with Nicky. Right.
Well, just promise me you won't be alone with him.
Is that all? It's not, is it?
I'd rather see him than me.
Oh, Steve, come here. Still think so. Good, now I've got to go.
I've got the place to myself.
Not now, but soon, I promise.
Come here, Mum.
Oh, thanks, love. It's really hot on your own.
Oh, shouldn't you be awake?
Yeah, but I just wanted to be nice for your dad when he comes home for Christmas.
Yeah, it won't be nice if you get the sack, will it? Now go on and get changed. I'll do this myself, then we can finish off tomorrow when we're both off.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
I really am sorry about last night, you know.
I know you are.
I know it was out of order.
Yeah, well... You just went completely over the top as usual. I know you'd do nothing to hurt me. And you're going to steer well clear of her from now on, aren't you?
Don't you worry.
Thank you.
Lisa, hi. Come in. Place is full of smoke. I had a pan on. I was upstairs and I didn't know.
It's like waiting for the kiss of death.
Oh, me and Anthea know all about that, don't we, Anth? Or has Ron sorted out his halitosis?
Right then. Which one first? The bad news or the bad news?
Go on. Give us the bad news.
There isn't a single one of you that's even close to your eating plan.
That's not news. That's common knowledge.
What's the point in having a plan if you're not going to stick to it?
At least the good news is the hat pin of Brookside Parade hasn't turned up.
She's all bone and no brains, that one.
Hi, everyone. Sorry I'm late, Katie. Busy, 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 I'm afraid. Here's my eating plan. I have stuck to that like glue. I mean, if you're determined to lose weight, it's easy, isn't it? Especially with aspirations like me. It's all about exercise as well, though, isn't it? I mean, there's no point sticking to a food diary and then sitting around doing nothing all day.
My diet gives me plenty of exercise, thanks very much. Hey, I expect Ron keeps you going as well, eh, Al? Once a month.
Perfect. I think Katrina deserves a prize, everyone.
So, what could be worse news than that?
The weigh-in, of course.
And the kids have been okay with the coffin being here?
Oh, we've been fine, yes. Almost as if we've been a proper family again in a strange sort of way.
Max, I've come because I'm worried. I've been on to the undertakers again, and they say you still haven't made arrangements for the funeral.
Oh, funeral, yeah.
Why not?
Would you like a cup of tea?
No, thank you. I want to know why you haven't buried my sister yet. And why you're keeping her here like this.
The real reason?
Yes, of course.
I think you'd better sit down.
£4.5
On.
Off?
You beat me by a pound.
Maybe I've been getting regular exercise after all.
Hey, you want to watch your door? It's dodgy, remember?
Beth.
Well, you know I hate heights.
Just get on.
Ugh.
£2?
I have lost £2.
Are you sure these scales are right? Positive.
Oh, Kate Moss, move over.
I can't understand it.
Me neither.
Hey, Lance's plan must be working after all.
Lance's plan?
Oh, yeah, I've been sticking to it like glue. Oh, me too.
I think we all have, haven't we?
Oh, definitely.
Lance's plan.
I am to blame for Susanna's death. All she wanted was to be married to the man that she loved and bring up her children. Married to the man who loved her. Well, I always loved her. Passionately, that was something that never died in either of us. Did we fight? Yes. Did I cheat on her? Yes. You can imagine how much I regret that now. But I knew I always loved her. That's what I told her the night that she died. See, I knew that it would come to a head sooner or later. I mean, I just couldn't help it. And she looked so beautiful, her standing there. I loved her so much, and I couldn't let her go. Not my...
I'm sorry, Max.
A little bit of what you fancy does you good.
Yeah, that's about it. And a nutshell, isn't it, girls?
With cream and Tobago sauce, if you fancy it.
What's up?
You're interfering with a carefully prepared professional plan.
Well, it's worked, hasn't it?
You don't know without a plan.
But it is a plan, that's the whole point.
What? You know, stuff yourself and hope for the best?
No. Stuffing yourself is a rejection of life. Whereas, well, a little bit of what you fancy embraces life. It encourages joy, and when you're happy, you don't have to stuff yourself.
And you lot fell for that. Suppose you paid him your subs and all.
I'll be giving him a great big tip as well.
Well, okay. You think that's good? We still haven't weighed Katrina.
Oh, good. Here we go.
Stand back, girls. Make room for her.
All right, somehow you've managed to do quite well, but this is what can happen if you stick to a carefully prepared plan. Come on, show them, Katrina. Wow.
Gosh, that's incredible. How light am I?
You've put on 3 pounds. Al, is it okay?
Check it out. Christy brought this over for your room.
Cool. Teddy bears, no way.
No, not for you. Your room.
What do you mean?
Me and you'll be sharing again.
Hello? My room.
I've got a good mind to sue. Something like that could ruin my career.
Shame, really, you being so hard on yourself while we were cheating away.
Hey, Lance's plan is not cheating. Have some faith and let her enjoy a banoffee pie.
I feel ever so guilty.
Now, guilt is something you've got to let go of. That's if you want to enjoy life and lose weight. It's like I said, you can't have one without the other. Now, open wide.
What's going on?
We're celebrating.
Celebrating what exactly?
Well, the success of Lance's plan. Katrina's joined now.
Shall we see?
Yeah, we're taking the thing onto a whole new level, aren't we, girls?
You know what? You can forget it. Flaming Stemman Club, it's dissolved as of now.
Ah, just the woman I wanted to see.
Bev, I am so sorry.
Don't you dare.
No, it wasn't your fault, any of it. I just feel terrible, though, honestly.
I was just worried, that's all.
Why, what's happened now? What about your poor mum? I wouldn't be worrying about her. She just gets carried away with herself.
Well, she has had a tough time lately.
Yeah, but there's no excuse to be acting like a teenager.
Well, don't be embarrassed on my account. I mean, it's a big thing for a woman, you know, when a fella goes off the rails.
Has he not been getting on lately? Well, he's been in no fit state of mind, really.
So, I don't suppose they bother with one another anymore, do they?
Oh, God knows.
Must be very lonely, you know. I mean, a woman her age. Still got plenty of passion left in her.
Too much passion by half, if you ask me.
Well, she's bound to get carried away every now and then, isn't she?
Yep. Once she gets going, she can't seem to stop herself. I feel for her, you know. I honestly do.
Very understanding, Beth.
Always been my strongest point, though. Understanding things.
I'm so sorry, Lisa. I didn't mean to.
It's all right. I feel the same way myself.
What?
That it was my fault Susanna died.
No, no. No, it really was my fault.
I related so strongly to what you were saying. Except I did let her go. Imagine how that feels. I abandoned my own sister. Gave up on her completely.
Well, I don't think that Susanna would feel that.
I keep thinking about us when we were children. She was such a happy little girl. Really beautiful. We were so close. And now we'll never have that again. And I might have been able to prevent it. Oh, I couldn't wait to pass judgment on everything she did, and on you. I had a great pleasure in not coming to the engagement party. What if I'd turned up the night she died? Like someone might the night before their sister got married. We would have talked. Who knows?
I'm sorry.
Oh, Max.
Who's our Anthony?
He's hiding upstairs in his old room.
What do you mean, his old room?
Christy brought them round, said it was for our aunt's room. Took it as a bit of a shock. We both did, actually.
I didn't ask Christy to get this.
Well, surely you must have spoke to me, Dad, about moving him into my room.
I'm sorry, love.
It's anyone to talk to. I'm fine.
You don't look it.
I sort of took it out on our aunt. I mean, I talked to him about it without even thinking what it might do to him.
We should have talked to you.
It's okay. I mean, I'll be getting a place of my own soon. Probably. I'm a big boy now.
I'm not trying to squeeze you out, you know.
I know. It's okay. Look, I want you to have this baby. I just don't think our aunt does, that's all.
Thank you, Max.
Whatever for?
Making it real. Somehow it hadn't sunk in. I think my guilt was stopping me looking at it all. I'm going to miss her.
It's the most beautiful thing that ever happened to me.
And I always had you down as a womanizer.
Well, I was that, all right.
Yes, but you also loved her. That's what I realize now. I almost envy her. To be loved like that must be quite something.
I love her still.
Me too. More than I ever did. Oh, no.
Now, have I been worried about you today? I'd have been over sooner, but the bar was busy.
How are you? Not bad, considering. I'm glad I've seen you.
Don't. Now, before you go offering to pay for the damage, I won't hear any of it.
I was out of order.
Were you, though? I mean, I know she's my flatmate and everything, but if she was sleeping with some older woman while she was going out with my daughter, I'd be the first to give her a slap.
Well, it was none of my business.
If you ask me, she's to blame for this, you know. This mysterious older woman. Don't suppose you know who she is, do you?
No, I've no idea, no.
Apparently she's married, but just doesn't know Mark, who she doesn't love anymore. She's probably one of those who's in the closet, isn't she? Desperate to leave hubby, but scared stiff after all these years. I mean, she could be someone we know.
To be honest with you, I'm not very interested.
Oh, I am.
Well, I'd stay well out of it if I were you.
Oh, why? Why's that then?
Oh, just let them get on with it, you know. I mean, it's probably some stupid infatuation.
You wouldn't be saying that if you saw what it was doing to Shelley. Now, I am going to find out who it is. And when I do, I'm going to blow the whole thing apart. Draw.
I have to admit, I was worried. I couldn't work it out. But now it's obvious. You've been grieving.
Very much so.
Perfectly natural under the circumstances.
Absolutely.
So it's agreed, then?
What, sorry?
About the funeral.
What do you mean?
Well, now that we've talked about it and we both feel better, we should go ahead and make the arrangements.
Oh.
It's what we both need, isn't it? Closure.
Yes, of course.
Would you like me to fix it up?
No, I'll do it and be fine. And I'll let you know. Oh, Lord. It's at the time I really must be picking up my children.
Sorry, I've stayed far too long.
That's no problem. Anyway, bye.
My coat.
Can I come in?
Can't stop me now, can I?
It's still your room. It will be for months yet.
Then I'll be homeless.
Don't be daft. You'll still live here with us.
I've only been in this room 2 minutes.
I'm sorry, Aunt. We should have talked to you about it.
You promised me I'd have my own room. I didn't even want to come here before that. You never keep your promise.
Oh, that's not fair.
You promised me we'd go to Blackpool for our holidays.
And I meant it. As soon as the baby's born.
Oh, yeah, right. The baby isn't even born yet. And I'm homeless. What's going to happen then, eh?
Bev!
What now?
You won't believe what's happened. Oh, I just don't know what to do.
Well, calm down and spit it out.
It's Fred.
Why? What's happened to him?
He's coming to Liverpool.
God, you're worrying the life out of me then.
Who the hell's Fred?
He's my boyfriend from Brazil.
Sorry I asked.
Look, I'm thrilled for you, lads. Honest, I am, but I'm on a mission here. Look, I won't be long. I'll come back. You can tell me all about it, but this is very urgent.
Oh.
I don't suppose you want to hear about it, do you?
If I must.
He's absolutely gorgeous, and he speaks fluent Portuguese, because that's what they speak over there, you know. Portuguese.
So, what are you making?
Amends.
Oh, nice one. I've had a very busy day.
Oh, yeah? Doing what?
Playing the detective.
Don't tell me. You discovered that the person who broke your vase was none other than Jackie Corkill.
You're not far wrong. You know, it must be a terrible burden, keeping a secret. I mean, take you and this older woman of yours. How hard is it keeping that a secret?
Oh, it hasn't been easy.
Don't you wish you could tell someone?
Yes, but I'm not going to.
Well, now you don't have to, because I already know. So you can have all the relief without any of the pain of telling. A little birdie told me.
No little birdies know about it, Beth.
Oh, they do now.
Who?
Well, who is it, or who told me?
Don't be cruel.
It's Jackie Corkill, isn't it? I'm right, aren't I? Oh, come on, I know I am. It all adds up.
Okay. Yes.
Oh, my God. You have done it with Jackie Corkill. Oh. And Lindsay Corkill. You dirty mare. What do you see in her? She's pushing 50. She's married. She works in the garage.
Max has only paid the rent till New Year's Eve. And Fred's staying till the 10th of January. What are we going to do?
Sorry, I think it got me mixed up with someone else.
What?
Someone who gives a damn about Clint and whatever rubbish it is he's getting for Christmas.
Oh, so you've been given a day for the funeral?
No, not exactly.
For Brookie tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Now, next tonight, Penny Mallory continues her efforts to make things better. Our country roads and rural villages may be quaint, but are they safe? Accident Black Spot, coming up.
I'll be out in the back garden if you need anything.
Oh, at last I have got you on your own. You are going to have to tell me all about you and Jackie Corkill.
Oh, I've told you, Beth.
Yeah, but I still can't believe it, can I? You are going to have to tell me everything.
There's nothing much to tell.
Well, it's a bit mad, isn't it? I mean, you and her. Out of all the women you could have gone for. Jackie Corkill. Are you crazy or what?
I think I must be.
Can I just go in for this afternoon?
Not when you've got the flu.
I haven't even got a temperature no more. Feel me yet?
You can stay here and get better.
And I'll get left behind if I don't go to school.
Last week you were swinging the lead and venting diseases. What's going on? And anyway, I've asked my mum to come and sit with you while I'm at the hospital.
I don't even need her to sit with me. I'm okay. I want to go to school.
You're staying here.
I'm fed up with this place.
What's wrong with you?
Get lost.
He wants to go back to school, this Avi.
What's wrong with that?
He's ill.
I'm not.
You want to go to school?
Just because you used to bunk off.
No, I did it once, and that's because you grasped me up.
Please, Mum.
No.
You are seriously weird.
Get lost.
That's enough, the lot of you.
Can I use the phone?
Go on. And you go and have a lie down in your room.
It's not my room no more, is it?
Go! I'm sorry I laughed before.
Oh, forget it. I was laughing as well. Kind of feel better for it, you know. Sort of relieved.
I just don't understand you and Jackie. I mean, I'm not being funny, but you don't exactly seem a match made in heaven.
Well, what about Ron? You told me you once loved him. What attracted you two to each other?
God knows, but it's what you see in her that I'm interested in.
She's strong.
So what do you do together? Arm wrestling?
The life she's led with Jimmy and the family, she's got them through all sorts. She's carried them.
You can say that again.
She's honest as well. The whole family's been branded as crooks, but Jackie hasn't. She wouldn't steal a pin off a millionaire. She's moral, too. I mean, she knows what she believes in, and she sticks to it, come hell or high water. And she'll defend her family no matter what it takes, and that's attractive.
Yeah, but a lot of people are like that, aren't they? I mean, what do you see in her? She's pushing 50. She's married. She works in the garage.
They're just labels, Bev. People don't see her like I do. She's beautiful.
Bit much, isn't it?
Oh, you haven't looked at her. She's just Jackie Corkill to you. If you look at her eyes and her hair and when she smiles, she's got real beauty. And I think it shines through all that wife and mother and garage stuff.
You do love her, don't you?
Do they have Christmas trees in Brazil? Yeah, of course they must. It's a Catholic country, isn't it? Anyway, even if they don't, I want that flat decorated like something off a Christmas card. A proper English Christmas for Fred. Hey, you are going to help me, aren't you?
Of course I will. Oh, it'll be great now that Max and them screaming kids have gone. Especially that Harry.
Oh, Harry's lovely.
Well, if you'd ask me, Lance, he's not right in the head.
Don't be so rotten. If you'd ask me, all this screaming kid stuff is just you trying to cover up your natural instincts.
I haven't got any. They're all brats.
Well, it's a pity Harry and Emma aren't going to be with us at Christmas.
You what?
Well, Fred's brilliant with kids, you know. I suppose he's coming from a big family. Yeah, he's got loads of nephews and nieces and cousins.
Yeah, well, as long as he doesn't fetch them all with him, it doesn't bother me. All I want is Christmas and New Year and no Max.
Oh, God, no! I never thought.
Max has only paid the rent till New Year's Eve, and Fred's staying till the 10th of January. What are we going to do?
Right, I'm going to have to shoot. Got to go to the bank and then start my Christmas shopping.
Look, thanks for listening. I feel much better for having talked about it.
Aye, you know what I am when things get tough.
This doesn't have to get out, Bev.
What? You sleeping with Jackie Corkill? It's the biggest scandal to hit this place in years. Don't kid yourself.
Oh, no. The only people who know are Jackie, me and you. And that's the way it's going to stay. Lindsay mustn't ever find out.
OK, I won't tell anyone.
And that means you not telling Dave.
But he's my fiancé. We tell each other everything.
No. You mustn't tell him.
Shirley, I trust him. We're getting married.
I don't want him knowing, Bev. Look what happened last time. 5 minutes and he was running to Lindsay, so just don't tell him, OK?
OK.
Oh, I thought I'd never get back in time, town. I was going crazy.
Started your Christmas shopping?
Well, I tried to, but didn't get any further than buying for Clint. Have you seen it?
You've gone a bit over the top, haven't you?
Oh, well, I brought me Slimming Club money, but who cares? Right, what do you think of that?
Very nice.
And you made up with this. It's an old Doctor Who annual. And I got that American whiskey likes and all. Here's that. And wait till you see these. Look at them. Brilliant, aren't they?
If you say so.
OK, so you're not interested. I suppose you prefer to be buying prezzies.
Sorry, I think I got me mixed up with someone else.
What?
Someone who gives a damn about Clint and whatever rubbish it is he's getting for Christmas.
Isn't your father here yet?
What time's your appointment?
In 40 minutes. Where is he? Steve, will you watch what you're doing?
What?
You're slopping beans all over the place. Be careful.
Leave it, I'll tidy it up.
You always leave your mess if I'm not here.
No, I don't.
You always do it.
Oh, shut up.
That's enough. Where have you been?
Block lav in the science block. Don't panic. Just have a quick drink and then we're off.
You can get a drink there.
I'm gasping.
We should be on our way now.
Don't panic. It's only a scan. What are you going to be like when you're 9 months gone? What are you two doing here? Oh, you haven't got that flu thing like our aunt, have you?
2 free periods.
Right. What about you? Oi, cloth ears. What are you doing here?
Time in loo for last Sunday.
Ah, a bit of afternoon delight with our trona, eh?
Marty.
Do I see a bit of a blush?
If you need to know, I won't be seeing her. She's decided to have the afternoon with that Carl fellow, the model agent.
Well, you're not jealous, are you?
Of course he is.
But she's a model, isn't she? Models have agents. What's the problem?
Well, I told her I was having a savvy off, and then she goes and tells me she's seeing that pillock again.
Why didn't you stop it?
Just shut up, you.
All these model agents are into is drugs and prostitution. Saw it on the telly.
The more I think about it, the worse it is. I promised Fred parties and clubbing and all sorts. And I need new clothes. And money for presents and Christmas food and drink. Where are we going to get the cash for all that and the rent for the flat? Oh. If we're thrown out our Fred's here, I will die. This is a nightmare. No, it's worse than a nightmare.
Oh, will you stop panicking?
Leanne, we're going to get evicted.
We're not. We're in that flat and we're staying there.
Oh, yeah, Al.
Never you mind. You just concentrate on getting things sorted for Fred and leave it to me.
New Year's only a couple of weeks away.
Oh, will you just forget about it? We've got plenty of time. We are in that flat and we're staying put, right? This is really important for you and I'm not going to let anything spoil it for you, OK?
Great, and thanks for coming. Bye.
Max.
Oh, hi.
Hey, how are you?
Fine.
How are the children?
Oh, they're great. They're just round at Trina's Tots at the moment.
Who was that?
That was the undertaker.
Oh, right, so have you got a date for the funeral?
No, not exactly.
But the undertaker's just been, can't he give you a date?
Well, he's not really the undertaker, he's the undertaker's assistant.
Oh, well, can't he give you a date?
No, not really.
Well, why was he here then?
Well, he has to, he's come to check on Susanna, you know, to see.
Why?
Well, he's come to check, you know, he's come to see.
Every day?
Yes, every day, until the funeral.
Which hasn't been arranged.
Well, yes, it's not as easy as that.
Max, can I come in? I think we need to talk.
Nisha, have the dressings that we ordered come in yet?
No, they're due next week.
Well, can you call them and chase them up, please? We're down to rock bottom.
Yeah, sure.
No, damn it. What idiot has left these lot here?
It's Katie's.
Well, can you tell her to please put it away? It makes us look sloppy.
You heard what the man said.
You have someone coming every day to take the lid off that. It's sick.
I know, but...
Max, you've got 2 kids living with you. What sort of an effect could it have on them?
Oh, they don't see anything. I make sure the children are elsewhere when he comes round.
Yeah, but it's bad enough having a coffin in the house, for God's sake. I don't want Harry seeing that every day of his life.
I know it's not ideal, but...
Then get the funeral sorted. Why haven't you got a date, Max? Why are you not doing anything to put your own wife to rest? All this, it's not right. Why are you dragging your feet like this?
It's Lisa.
Well, what about her?
She's been, well, indecisive.
What, cremation or burial, you mean?
She was round here yesterday. She was in tears. She was really upset. She doesn't want to let Susanna go. She can't bear to say goodbye to her sister.
feel terrible about my mum and about what happened. And...
don't worry about it.
Yeah, I'm mortified. She was well out of order, I'm sorry.
Forget it, Linz. Absolutely nothing to be sorry about.
Yeah, but violence. That's not like my mum.
She was just sticking up for her daughter. Isn't she always?
How can you be so understanding? She shouldn't have attacked you.
Still in one piece, aren't I?
I just wanted to apologise. Can I buy you a drink to make up for it?
There's no need.
Please. I'd really like to.
Please. Okay, yeah. Why not?
Yeah, I understand that. She didn't see Susanna for a while before she died. It must be hard to let go.
She was so upset.
But Max, the coffin can't stay here forever. Surely she realises Harry and Emma are going to see her every day.
The children don't know that the mother's inside.
Well, that's not the point. It's not right. Look, why don't I ring Lisa and see if I can try and talk her around?
No, no, there's no need.
Well, we get on pretty well. It's no problem.
No, I'd rather you didn't. You know, I'm just about getting there with getting her to let go. It's just that, well, I don't want to make her feel pressurised.
Yeah, OK. But you've got to keep some pressure on her.
Yeah, I will.
Been busy?
It's chocolate lunch, but managed.
Look at that.
Oh, isn't it sweet? Back in each other's loving arms.
No, they're not. They can't be.
It's probably just some tiff.
It was a bit more than that. Has Shelley got a death wish or what?
What are you going on about?
I can't tell you.
Oh, well, don't say then.
Well, I've only just found out myself. It is the hottest goss.
You're not going to believe this.
I've been thinking a lot since my mum lost her the other day.
Look, I told you, just forget it ever happened, okay?
It's not that. It's me and you.
Linz, this drink is about us getting back together. Well, it's not gonna happen.
I've got that message.
So?
The sex was new and different. It was great. And I can accept it finishing. But what I can't stand is not being mates anymore. Can we stay friends?
Shell and Lindsay's mum.
That Jackie from the garage.
Not so loud.
Wow.
Now you know why I had to tell someone.
This is dynamite. TNT.
I'd love to know what they're talking about now. Hey, do you think she's changed her mind and confessed everything to Lindsay?
Right now, in here.
Stop it.
Oh, it'd make the Jimmy Springer show look like Blue Peter.
Bev, forget you ever heard this. If Jimmy or Lindsay find out, it could blow that family apart.
I've brought you a drink, love.
Thanks.
Aren't you going to come downstairs and watch the telly?
No.
Don't you think you're being a bit soft about this bedroom business? Your mum told me. And it's not making her very happy. She thinks you don't want her to have a baby.
I don't see why I have to get pushed out of this room. It's the first time I've been on my own.
That's what I want to talk to you about. You're going to have your own room.
Didn't Mum say you could stay in this one?
Well, no, but I spoke to her, and I've decided to decorate my box room. Look, you can bring all your stuff over, you can leave it there, and you can come and stop over whenever you want. So, what do you think about that?
It's great, thanks.
You don't seem very thrilled about it.
It's dead nice, but doesn't make up for me being pushed out of this room. Don't babies sleep with the mum and dad anyway?
Well, for a while, yes, but it's better they have their own room.
So I get pushed out of this one.
Oh, aren't you pleased for your mum? She really wants this new baby.
Well, all I want is my own room.
But you'll feel better when it's real. It isn't real to you yet, but your mum will get a photo from the hospital and you'll be able to watch it growing inside her. You love Ardell and Steve, don't you? Well, this baby's going to love you just the same. And when that baby's living here, whatever you think, you'll love that baby as well. I know you. And I know I'm right.
I've tried this being friends thing before, after relationships finished, and it's just never worked. I just don't want you to go through some of the unpleasantness I've had.
So that's a no, then?
No, I just want you to be aware that it can be hard. You know, we could both be making a big mistake.
Well, I don't think so.
I must admit, I've missed you and your family. You're not like some of the friends I've had. We do get along, don't we?
Yeah.
My pessimism versus your optimism. Your good humour and my lack of. Yeah. It'd be great to be mates. I think it's worth the effort.
Did you just clock that? She's just touched Lindsay's hand.
Stop spying on them. Let them get on with their lives.
What are you doing, piping them two?
Shh.
Well,
you know Shelley's a leser. Well, you know she's been seeing Lindsay.
Bev.
Big deal.
Well, the thing is, they split up, but now we think they've got back together.
What did they split up over?
Well...
Bev.
Am I missing out on something here?
Oh, no, it's just, well, Shelley's a friend. She shouldn't be talking behind her back.
Oh, you can tell me, Bev.
No, Lance is right. It's private.
Ah, well, suit yourself.
You nearly slipped up then. Ollie-Ann doesn't like secrets. She don't be forced to go and speak her mind. No, don't say anything.
Can you see its feet? Oh, isn't it tiny?
See its head there?
It's great seeing it live on the video thing, wasn't it, love?
Oh, brilliant. It's his little heart beating away.
Oh. Nan, Aunt, come and have a look.
How did it go, love?
It was great. I've got my folder and my scan picture.
They reckon it's due on the 5th of July, Bridge.
Oh, let's have a look.
Look, isn't it tiny? Oh.
60 millimetres. About as big as a tangerine.
Oh, look, Aunt.
What do you think about that? Can you see the feet?
Tiny.
Never had any of that high-tech stuff when our Steve was born.
We certainly didn't. I think it's marvellous being able to see it grow like this.
The midwife was great, though, wasn't she?
Oh, yeah. You'd be certainly well looked after there.
Can you see the feet, Mum?
Oh, yes. God love him.
Or her.
No way do I want to know whether it's a boy or a girl.
Madonna did. I'm one of the Spice Girls.
Yeah, I know, but you can't tell from the first scan. Anyway, I don't care. Even when they know from the next scan, I don't want to. I want it to be a surprise. Can't wait.
Oh, neither can I.
Thanks, love.
Stop staring at them.
I can't help it. It'll blow up any minute.
This has got to stop. You are going to explode if you don't get this out your head.
I still can't believe it.
Oh, I wish you'd never tell me. My nerves are in shreds, and that's from just watching you.
Look, if those two get it back together, right, then it just opens up a path to Jackie for Shelley, doesn't it?
Look at me. You've got to promise not to tell another soul.
How can I?
Because this is dangerous. Promise. Cross your heart and hope to die, eh? And no cross fingers. Go on. I promise. Cross my heart and hope to die.
You're just being soft now.
Go on.
Okay, I promise. Cross my heart and hope to die.
There, it's done. Forget you'd even heard about it.
I couldn't bear us not talking.
Neither could I.
No.
Shall I get some more drinks? Just to seal the friendship.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right, well, I'm finished here. If you need me, I'll be at the health centre. I thought I'd ask for the slot to be moved.
I did tell her. Sorry.
You heard me mention it. I don't want this place looking like the Harrods Coffee Lounge. And if you bring in shopping, please put it away.
Yeah, sorry.
Good night.
Night, night. Yeah, go on. Laugh. What? The minute you saw I bought Prezzies for Clint, you stuck the knife in, showing me up to Darren. I can see exactly what you are. You're a bitter, jealous bitch. I can see right through you. You couldn't hold on to him, and you're sick now because we're together.
Don't fool yourself, Katie. You're welcome to him. As far as I'm concerned, he doesn't exist. You have no feelings for him.
Don't you fool yourself. Your first day here, you crying your eyes out over him.
Not because of him, because I'd wasted time and emotions over a spineless no-mark like Clint.
Don't talk about him like that.
Truth hurts, doesn't it? Of course he's spineless. He wouldn't know how to spell the word backbone. Haven't you seen him with his big brother? When he says jump, little Clint says, how high, Robbie? If you're so sure about your big, strong man, ask him why he went to Spain. See if he's got the spine to tell you the truth about that.
What about Spain?
Ask your boyfriend.
Tell me.
You won't like it.
I said tell me.
Robbie beat the living daylight out of some bloke in a pub. That's his hobby, you know. Or maybe you don't know. He gets his kicks out of violence.
What's that got to do with Clint?
Well, the bloke that Robbie put into hospital just so happened to belong to some big family of hard knocks. Things got so heavy that Robbie ran off to Benidorm. But he probably got frightened on his own, so guess who followed him over there like a little poodle? He dumped his career, he dumped his friends, he dumped me, the girl he said he wanted to marry, just so that he could run off with some psycho brother. Call that backbone. What a man, eh? What a man. Look, Katie, about what I said yesterday.
You said your piece, let's leave it at that.
Fine.
She needs to be laid to rest.
But what can we do?
You never know, you could get what I got, just stupid community service.
I took the blame, and I'm gonna go down.
I really miss it. I think you miss it too.
We're back to the close Friday night at 8 o'clock. Next tonight, Four continues to try and find the perfect antidote. Poison follows the work of the emergency services. Someone's just called in a toxic alert.
I was just on my way home and I saw you come in.
Do you want a coffee?
No. No, I just wanted to ask you something.
Sounds ominous.
I was wondering if you'd like to come round to mine for dinner tonight. You know, just as mates, just like we were saying.
Will Jackie be there?
Oh, don't worry, I don't think she's going to batter you again. Anyway, she's gone to see my dad today, then she's gone on to my Auntie Val's. Yeah.
But what if she came back? I mean, I'd sooner not take the risk. It could be really embarrassing.
Okay. Another time, then.
No. It was really nice of you to ask. Why didn't you come to the flat?
Do you think Bev would mind after what happened?
Oh, don't worry about that. We'll have the place to ourselves anyway. Bev and Dave will be down here till late.
That'd be great. What time?
Seven-ish.
Lovely. I'll bring a bottle of wine.
Cool.
See you later.
Hey.
They're carrying on like nothing's happened. They're still together. I can't fathom it.
You are getting obsessed and it isn't healthy.
Yeah, but the juiciest goss to hit Manor Park since the year dot. I mean, I want to know what Shelley's playing at. I thought she was into Jackie. What's she doing all lovey-dovey with Lindsay? I just be like marching over and asking her.
Stop it. You promised you'd forget all about that. Crossed your heart and everything. So mind your own business. Look, if you want to take your mind off things, you can help me make a banner.
Aye?
I'm going to do a banner, you know, for when Fred flies in. Big letters, loads of kisses, welcome Frederica. Oh, I can't wait. I'm counting the hours.
All right, Timo.
All right.
What's up with you?
What do you think's up? Crown Court tomorrow. Ring any bells?
Come on, mate, you're going to walk it. Community service, suspended sentence, whatever.
I'm going down. I can feel it.
Don't be so negative, man.
Look, as far as I'm concerned, I may as well be there now. Other people have got all these affairs to sort out when they're facing jail. But what have I got, eh? No money, no job. As far as I'm concerned, I'm just sitting here waiting to get banged up. I don't know what to do with myself.
Doesn't Emily get back today?
I've no idea.
You should be partying. Tonight we're going to hit the town.
You and me?
Get off everybody. Nikki, Steve, Katrina, Rachel, Mike, whoever. I'll start texting them now.
One big problem. No money.
No problem, because we're buying the ale. This is going to be the biggest bender yet. It's going to be wild, whether it's Tim's last night of freedom or not.
Hiya.
Busy?
Tell me about it.
Me. Have you seen anything of Max?
I want to take the kids to the nursery and that. Listen, Jack, I need to know about Susanna's funeral. It's been weeks since. I mean, shouldn't things be happening now?
Exactly what I thought.
What, is it the police holding things up or what?
No, Max said it's Lisa.
Lisa? Why?
Well, he said she's been merely upset and she's been finding it hard to let Susanna go. But Max seems to be under a lot of strain, you know.
You know it, Jack. Couldn't you have a word?
He won't let me. Doesn't want to put Lisa under any pressure at all.
Well, maybe, but she needs to be laid to rest.
But what can we do? Will you see to these for me?
I'm busy. I'll do them when I'm ready.
Look, Katie, about what I said yesterday.
You said your piece. Let's leave it at that.
Fine.
Hi, Alicia. Hiya.
Hiya, what are you doing here?
I'm sure the message off to your own. Him and his mate Tim have invited us to, and Robbie and Jackie into town tonight. You're up for it?
What's our staff Christmas do? You're invited for the meal.
Oh, I know.
I want you there.
Can't you just meet me in our lobby later? Give us a bell on the mobile and then come to the club with him.
But do we have to go with Robbie?
Jackie's going as well. It's all fixed. And what's wrong with going with our Robbie?
And you should tell me why you left and went to Spain.
Hello. Lisa, hi. Yes, yes, I've been in touch with the undertaker and things are underway. I see, the problem is getting a date. You know, it's winter. Christmas is coming up. I don't know. They're a bit pushed. We'll just have to wait a bit longer. I don't know how long. I'm waiting for him to get back in touch with me, you see. You know, that's the door. I think that might be the undertaker now, so... Yes, I will ring you as soon as I have a date, okay? Bye-bye.
All right, Max, can I come in?
Yes, come in. What can I do for you?
I've been talking to Jackie about the funeral.
Right.
When's it gonna be?
Nisha said Robbie put that lad in hospital.
He did, yeah, but he asked for it.
What's that supposed to mean?
It was self-defense.
Are you sure about that?
Look, he was winding Robbie up all night. He started picking on him, then he hit Robbie first.
Nisha said Robbie's always fine. She said it was his hobby.
Crap.
Nisha said that you were his poodle and that's why you went to Spain, to escape from the lad's mate. She said he more or less pushed you into going.
Nisha says, she'll say anything to get at me. Or you. Can't you see that?
Did he push you into going?
He had to go to Spain. That lad's mates are heavy. They've done our lobby over good style.
But why did you go?
Because she was giving me so much earache. You don't know what she's like. She never let up. She doesn't even like our lobby anyway. Even before this garbage about him and that lad.
Does he get into fights just for the hell of it, like?
No way. He's just a big, strong lad and balloon heads in pubs and clubs. You're looking for trouble. Well, he always has to have a go at our Robbie. He doesn't look for trouble. He never has done.
Okay, I believe you.
Are we going to do this night out, then?
Yeah, after we've been to the staff, too.
Is she going to be there?
Yeah.
Well, don't listen to her, eh? She's a troublemaker for me. And now she's saying it on you and all.
I know things went wrong between me and Susanna, but I did care for her.
I know.
And it upsets me that she's still here. I want her to be at rest.
Yeah, I realise that.
And there's the kids as well. It's not nice for them seeing that, is it?
Well, it's Lisa, you know. I can't stand the thought of upsetting her.
Well, don't you think she's being unreasonable?
But Susanna, it's her only sister. There were just the two of them.
It's not normal, Max. She needs to be buried. Left in peace. Look, why do you let Jackie have a word with Lisa?
I can't allow that. No, she is too upset. I don't want to push her over the edge. She is a very sensitive person.
I think I might be able to talk to her.
Mick, no.
Then you'll have to do it, Max. You'll have to let her know that she can't carry on like this. In the long run, the funeral will help her come to terms with it all.
All right. Okay, I'll talk to her.
Good. I think you should get on to the undertaker to make the arrangements. Even if she is upset about everything, you've got to put your foot down, Max.
I know. You're right.
Away. I want to see you.
Well, there's no point.
I want to talk to you.
Well, I want you to forget about me.
Why won't you let me in? What's the matter with you?
Because this time tomorrow, I'm going to be in jail. So why bother with me, eh?
What are you saying that for? Look, stop giving up. You never know. You could get what I got, just stupid community service.
Think about it. I took the blame, and I'm going to get sent down. So what's the use in talking, eh? What good's that gonna do?
But Tim, I love you. Let's just go to your room and talk.
Em, just go home.
Why are you doing this? I love you.
Leave me alone.
Don't you love me?
You know I do. But it's not gonna work for either of us. Look, I'm going to prison. I'm gonna be locked up for ages. Will you just forget about me, Em? It's over. Forget about me and find someone else.
Please, no.
Look, that's what I want. Now, will you do as I said and just go away and leave me alone?
No, please.
To the health centre, and then it's time to let her hair down. Aren't you two ready for your finery yet?
Just going.
Right, well, Victoria and I will see you at the restaurant as arranged. Let's have a good time, shall we?
Yeah.
Look, I don't know what's wrong between the two of you, but it's been obvious all day, and it'll be a disaster tonight if you don't make it up. So can we please try to bury whatever hatchet it is that's causing all the trouble? Can we please try? I'll see you later.
Look, us carrying on like this is stupid.
Is it?
I told you the truth and you're taking it out on me. Talk about shooting the messenger.
Well, you got it wrong. I've talked to Clint and Robbie was defending himself against some bully. He's not what you're trying to make out, some psycho.
That's exactly what he is, a psycho. He gets off on violence. He's dangerous.
Rubbish.
Say what you want, but I'll tell you this. If my best mate was going out with Robbie Moffat, I'd be worried.
Aw, so everything's okay with you and the baby?
Fine. It's really amazing seeing its heart beating on the video.
I remember going the first time with Harry. Oh, I was terrified.
You still seeing anything, Harry?
No, not really. I'm a bit worried.
Yeah?
Yeah, well, Susanna's still not being buried. Max has got a coffin in the house.
That's normal, isn't it?
Yeah, but after all that time, I don't want Harry seeing that. Especially when there's an undertaker fella coming every day to check that the body's okay.
Have you talked to him?
Well, I've tried. But it's Lisa, who's on my sister. She can't face the funeral, letting her go. Max is trying to talk around.
Poor Max. Must be terrible for him.
Oh, talk of the devil.
Can I help you?
Hi, Diane. Jackie, I'm in a bit of a fix regarding the children. They're waiting next door at Katrina's to be picked up, but I need to go out for a few hours. I was wondering if you could take care of them.
Oh, I can't. I'm out clubbing tonight.
All right. What about you, Diane? Could you look after the children?
Sorry, it's Christmas almost. I'd be lucky if I get out of here by 9.
I see.
What about your daughter? Could she help?
I'm sure she could. She'll have to have them at our house.
Oh, great. All right. Well, I'll give them some supper and I'll bring them over.
No problem.
Good. Yeah, see, I really do need to get out.
Do you have to see Lisa?
Yes. Oh, yeah. Yes. Lots to talk about, you know, with... Is that a scan?
Oh, don't worry, Max. I'm not expecting. Marty and I have had some good news. It's due in July.
Oh, congratulations. Right, so I'll bring them over later, yeah?
Yeah, you go ahead. I'll give Ardell a ring.
That's very kind. Thanks.
Bye, see ya. Poor Max. It's all over the place, isn't he? I hope he can talk some sense into Lisa. Right, you're done. And if that lad of yours doesn't like him, tell him I'll come round and batter him. He'll love it, thanks. You still going strong, you and Robbie? Yeah, great. Your eyes are shining just talking about him. Does it show? Does what show? I think I'm falling for him. And looking like you do, I'm sure he feels exactly the same. Oh, thanks.
Might be too early.
Oh, don't worry about it.
Hungry?
Oh, starving.
Oh. Well. Oh, should be another 5 minutes or so.
The table looks really nice. And I was going to order us a Chinese banquet takeaway for two. You needn't have gone to all that trouble.
Oh, no, it wasn't any trouble. I enjoyed doing it for you. Do you want to pour some wine?
Well, that's the cellar chocker. I think we'll get through Christmas now.
Thanks. Tired.
Knackered.
Have you been back to the flat?
Well, I took Josh to see his mate, and then I've been working my backside off in the cellar. Why?
Soon you'll be seeing Shelley.
Why would I want to see her?
No reason.
Yes, there is. You're obsessed with her every move these days.
I'm not.
You keep talking about her.
I don't.
I hope you're not the one that did the dirty with her and did Lindsay's head in.
Get off.
Me think the lady doth protest too much. She moved in and you knew what she was like.
What are you saying?
Well, I'm only joking, but you could be the one. The mysterious Mrs. X. The object of Shelley's lust.
Get off, Dave. Have you been drinking?
No, but I'd love a pint.
Yeah, well, help yourself.
What, you gonna get me one? I am your fiancé.
Help yourself.
I've touched a nerve.
What?
Well, is there something between you and her?
Don't be soft.
I'm serious. I mean, how do I know?
You share me bed.
So, you can swing both ways?
Oh, Dave, stop it, will you? It's not me.
Sure.
Look, it's not me. It's...
Dinner. What do you think? I want everything to be perfect. Do you think I should put something else on?
No, Lance, it's perfect. Fred will love it.
Is this guy really coming?
Yeah.
Sure of that?
Dave?
Well, it's just I thought this Brazilian catalogue man was some figment of your overactive imagination.
No.
Take no notice of him. He's just in a wind-up mood.
Prove it. Prove it he's real.
Dave, stop it.
Of course he's real.
Show us a picture, then. We haven't got any evidence, have we?
Well, I could show you hundreds of pictures of him.
Go on, then.
I can't. I'm working. I have got pickies, Bev, honest.
I know, love. You go and get them.
Go on, then. What are you waiting for?
You sure?
Go on. Go and get them.
Go on. Prove him wrong.
Hey, what phone's that here?
Yeah.
Somewhere special?
Might be.
Something bothering you?
I saw me ma this afternoon.
Say no more, I'm sorry I spoke.
You don't give a damn about her, do you?
Oh, drop it, Jay.
No, Mick, I won't drop it. It's been weeks now and she's still cut up over what you did to her.
Oh, grow up, will you? I haven't done anything to her.
You used her?
Look, I've had enough of this. I was cut up over Susanna and the wedding. And me and Yvonne were two consenting adults. Have you got that? Adults.
No, that's just you trying to creep your way out of it. You used her like she was some kind of tart or something.
Your mother's no tart. And I'm not proud of what we did. But I was the one who'd been kicked in the guts at me. I mean, has it crossed your mind that you might have been using me?
You are again, get! Hey, come on.
Hey, what the hell's going on? Jerome, get off him. What's all this about, eh?
If you don't drop this, you can bloody well find somewhere else to live. All right?
I haven't made your life very happy these past few weeks, have I?
I'm glad we managed to salvage something, though.
Yeah. I could kick myself for what I've put you through.
Shh. Let's just enjoy the meal. And I think we should ban all talk of the breakup, don't you?
Agreed.
Cheers, love. Well, I don't know why you tried to make him look so small. Fred coming over from Rio is a dream come true for Lance.
What proof do we have that this guy exists?
Because Lance doesn't lie, and now you've upset him.
Right. Got a few minutes to spare. Me and Fred at the Copacabana. Me and Fred at the terrace at the Hotel Miramar. Me and Fred catching the bus up to the Sugarloaf Mountain there. Is that enough proof for you?
OK, I believe you. You didn't tell us he looked like Freddie Mercury, though.
No, he doesn't. It's just the moustache.
All Brazilians have them. It's like a macho thing.
Oh, hey, he's showing a bit more than his moustache here, isn't he?
That's Fred messing about on the street with some of his mates.
Oh, Dave, have a look at this.
I can see all I need in here.
Oh, hey, he is just a little bit of a hunk, isn't he? Look at that body. He's got muscles on his muscles. I tell you, with a body like that, you're going to have to keep an eye on him, otherwise I'll be first in the queue.
I'll just go and make myself a sandwich.
Take no notice of him. I think Fred is lovely.
Whatever happened, I still value the time we were together.
I thought we put a ban on talking about us.
Only the break.
That's all right, then.
I got something I'd never had before. A relationship that wasn't all about power games. It was just about being gentle and caring with each other. I'd never had that before.
That's a lovely thing to say. Thanks. Do you want to eat this over here?
Yeah. Don't mind. I also learned something about making love.
Yeah?
That's about two equal people showing each other affection, not just demands and duty and all that. I'd never had that before. Not till I met you. I really miss it. I think you miss it too.
Oh, I love that one where Fred's wearing his suit and was standing by that big American car. I was thinking of getting it blown up and framed.
No, no, if you're going to do that, do it with that one. The one where you're outside the cathedral.
Yeah, it's nice, but...
Oh, you've got to. You look gorgeous, the pair of you. Hey, do you think you should get this one blown up?
Oh, the day I met Freddie Mercury.
Dave, that is enough.
I'll get the both of them done.
Hey, you know what you could do? I've got this leaflet upstairs from this firm in town, right? You give them a picky and they turn it into a framed oil painting.
Oh, is it, dear?
It's not that bad. Hey, and that picture I love would look fantastic as an oil painting. I was thinking of getting one of me and Dave done, you know, hung up behind the bar, give the place a proper family feel.
What?
Well, you know, that picture someone took of us in the park with Josh.
When was that?
Well, July, August. You must remember.
What park?
Croxteth.
Well, I haven't seen it.
Of course you have. Well, go and get it.
I'm not sure we should be doing this.
Under the circumstances.
I thought we were going to enjoy tonight.
Yeah, but...
Worry about tomorrow when it comes.
Shell, you haven't seen that packet of photos I was showing you the other day, have you?
Don't come in.
Oh, sorry. Got someone in there, have you? Hey, it's not Jackie Corkle, is it?
Sorry, Jackie. I'm really sorry.
What did she say?
I think it was just a slip of the tongue. I don't think she realises what she's saying.
She thought you were in here with me, Mum. Oh, my God. Mum's the married woman, isn't she? I couldn't tell you. I couldn't. You've been sleeping with me, Mum, behind my back when you were going out with me. God. How? Why?
right.
Listen, please.
Get off me.
Just listen.
I said get off.
Oh, my God. Who's that?
Bill?
Intrude. What are you on about? You're one of the family, kid.
Top of the stairs over there.
What's she doing here?
Catch this week's Brookside Omnibus tomorrow at 5 past 5 here on 4. Next tonight, 3 Leeds lasses go rural in She's Gotta Have It.
The three of them, mate, Tim.
Yep, looks that way.
Look on the bright side, lad. You might not get a custodial.
No, that's not what my brief says. He says this time tomorrow I'm going to be banged up.
So you're going for tonight, then, yeah?
Two rides.
Hey, have you seen the tree?
Yeah, at least it's the real one this year.
Where are we going? Where there's some decent-looking fellas.
Hey, you, I hate that.
Wherever there's an all-nighter.
Well, look, here we come.
Yes. It's Christmas!
Yay!
Lindsay, it isn't like it sounds, I swear.
My girlfriend slept with my mum, it sounds clear enough to me.
Please, can we just talk about this?
Don't touch me.
Well, it was a stupid thing to do. I know it was a stupid thing
you
to do.
You had sex with my mum, and then you brought me round here.
You virtually battered the door down.
You're disgusting.
No, look, it wasn't like it sounds.
Where's my handbag?
Look, can I explain at least?
Explain? Explain what?
That you've been climbing on top of my mum. That she's been here in our bed when she was just filling in for me when I was on late.
Actually, it happened round your mum's.
Oh. Well, that makes it all right, then.
It's not like we planned it or anything.
I just wonder who's going to be next. Our Kylie.
Listen, please.
Get off me.
Just listen.
I said get off. Now, I don't want you to touch me or come near me or even speak to me again, OK? Because you're sick.
You are choking, aren't you?
No, I'm deadly serious. I'm not drinking.
Mate, you've got to get blooded. This is your last night of freedom. You're going down tomorrow. It's got to be one to remember.
That's the point. I want to remember what freedom feels like. And anyway, I don't want to be standing in front of some judge smelling like a brewery, do I?
Your funeral, mate.
Yeah, it is.
Ow. What are you two playing at? Slime all over each other.
Isn't she absolutely gorgeous, Jackie?
Oh, is he on a promise or what? If he plays his cards right. Is Emily coming?
No.
How come it's Tim's last night?
Split up.
No.
Well, it's not much point if he's going to prison, is there?
Casey?
Hi, Jack.
Oh, you got me messages then?
Oh, thankfully I checked my phone.
How was your meal?
I have never been on such a boring night out in my life. I've just been to the medical centre Christmas do.
Oh, was it that bad?
What was it like, Clint?
Oh, Dr. Death never shuts up.
And Nisha was giving us daggers all night.
Well, I made up his ear anyway.
Where's Borstal Boys? He smashed you.
No, he's not drinking.
Go away. More fool him. Go on then. Get the ailing.
Mum? Mum?
Are you sure you didn't know she was in that room?
Of course I am.
You're not telling me Porky's, are you?
No.
Look me in the eye and tell me you didn't know Lindsay was in that bedroom.
Lance, I didn't know. I swear to you. Honest, I thought I was just messing about with Shelley. I feel terrible. What am I going to do?
There's nothing you can do now.
Shelley is going to kill me.
Yeah, well, Shelley should have thought that before she got involved in the mother-daughter action.
Me and my big bleeding mouth.
One of them is going to find out sooner or later.
Do you reckon?
And there's nothing you can do about it now, so...
Better get back to your balloons, then.
Oh, I can't do any more. I'm knackered.
Really? Thought you'd have plenty of puff in you.
You cheeky mare.
So, how long now, then?
2 hours, 42 minutes and 10 seconds.
Excited?
What do you think? I feel like all my birthdays and Christmases have come at once.
Carl, isn't it?
Yeah. Ah, Brittany.
What?
The girl I gave my car to at the pool party. Brittany Spears.
What are you doing sniffing around here?
I'm trying to find your mate.
Tim.
Katrina. Yeah, got a couple of addresses for her, but I'm not having much luck.
She's out with my sister.
Great. Wasted journey.
Doesn't have to be.
Oh, yeah?
I've been thinking about your offer.
And?
And I haven't made any decisions yet.
Well, how about a drink to talk it over?
Sounds. Do you want to town?
This time of year, too many office parties and drunk scallies for my liking.
OK, then. Another time.
Oh, no, I mean, if that's where you really want to go.
Sound?
Lins, what time? Where have you been?
I've got a visitor for you.
How's my little girl?
Dad.
Come here.
Oh. I told you he was coming in for Christmas.
Change, mate.
Hello. Oh, these queues are a joke.
Stop moaning, will you? This place is sound. Isn't it, Timothy?
Yeah, sound.
We should have just gone round a few of the bars.
And what would be the point of that? You're not drinking, he's not drinking.
It's not against the law, you know. Oh, sorry, Tim.
You on the pool tonight, eh, lad?
Why? Because I'm young, free and single, eh?
Well, you're free for tonight anyway.
Yeah, and you're not with Aunt Em anymore.
Cheers for reminding me, eh?
You know, you don't sound too cool about it.
Oh, you know.
Look, give it a call.
No. You made the right decision, haven't you?
Yeah.
So we just need you staying it all up again.
You look gorgeous.
Don't your hands are freezing?
Well, warm them up then.
Steve!
Come on, no one can see.
Get off.
Forget it then.
How much is it to get in here?
I don't know.
It's 20. 20 each?
Well, that's what clubs cost these days.
£40. I just spent 18 on a round.
Well, it's not like we're out every night, is it?
I know, but £40.
Rachel, it's Christmas.
Yeah, and we're skinned. Oh, look, should we go somewhere else?
Nah, it's good in here.
Oh, I know, but look at the queue and I'm freezing.
Yeah, we should try wearing some clothes. That usually helps.
Oh, when we pull a neck next time.
Please, just let them in.
Who?
Them girls, they were behind us.
Oh, yeah, I'll have a word.
What?
I'm not having that.
Robbie, where are you going? Robbie,
what's up?
Oh, he's gone to have a go with the bouncers. I'm going after him.
Hang on, Jackie, don't you be going down there.
All right, lads, coming in.
Oh, mate.
You are? Come here.
Robbie, stop it, will you?
Still not fast enough, mate, lad.
What's going on?
I don't know.
We're in.
He's all right.
What?
Finish a cracking, lad. Nice one, Bill.
All of us?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, Casey, Rachel.
Nice one, Rob.
Thanks.
Good score, lads. Hello. Not what you know.
Okay.
Robbie!
Lance, I've called the cab, so get that banner folded.
Okay, tar babe. Oh, this is it.
Oh, have you seen him? He's almost wetting himself with excitement.
Where did he meet this Brazilian god, then?
Dunno. Brazil, probably.
He's got you taken in anyway.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, you're just being your usual over-the-top self, that's all.
I'm not over-the-top.
You bloody are.
Tell me in what way I am over-the-top.
You're organising a Brazilian night.
Hey, shush!
To welcome the boyfriend, who you've never met, or some lad that works behind the bar.
Lance is not just a lad.
That's over the top.
No, it's called making the effort and being kind, something you know nothing about.
It's madness.
Here's me taxi.
So, how long now?
38 minutes.
Oh, well, you better get going. You don't want to lost and speak international.
Oh, my nerves are shot.
Oh, go on, otherwise the cab will go without you.
See ya.
Good luck. Oh, it's like a love story. Except no one's sick. Come on. Here he is.
Hello, son. Hello. Oh, there he is, my favourite lad. Are you Kyles? Where have you been?
Are you better now, Grandad?
Yeah. I think I am. Oh, come here. Give it our granddad a kiss. Oh, there they are, my two favourite people.
Look at him, Lance. Can't believe it. Yeah, I'm gonna be getting too excited. I'll be going back in a couple of weeks. Oh, I've missed him. Oh, been sitting in pine and every night for him, have you?
Just glad to have him home.
Hey, nice wallpaper, Jack. Right, I'll take these two up, shall I?
Yeah. Give me mum a chance to have a good chat.
You will not.
Oh, I haven't seen him for ages. I want to put him to bed.
You've only just set foot in the house. You sit down. I'll sort the kids out.
Bed's calling. Up the apples and pears.
Go on. I'll come up and spend the night.
You probably wouldn't be able to get Carly off to sleep anyway. She'd be too excited having a granddad home. What's the matter, Dad?
Nothing.
Are you crying for?
Oh. Just glad to be home, love.
Susanna. Can you hear me? Where are you? Are you here now?
And gone to Totty, haven't I?
Don't know what you're looking for, Stevie boy. With your bed in the supermodel in
there. Nick, there are no girls over there. Oh, what a shock.
And doesn't it bother you?
Jean, they can look in the garden without picking the flowers.
I can't stand the thought of Steve fancying someone else.
I'm sure Jerome fancies loads of girls. Doesn't mean he'd do anything about it. Come on.
Oh, my God. Who's that?
Lou.
Hey, babe, it's him.
What the hell has she got on?
How does he do it, eh? Yeah, but she looks like a right slapper.
Who cares?
Jealous, are we, boys?
He's got that Emily.
Not anymore.
Can you believe it?
What?
We're out!
I know, yeah.
Brilliant, isn't it?
I know, it feels weird.
No running out there.
in our basement.
Not Beth.
It's freedom.
I forgot what that feels like.
I know, should we do a runner and leave her with your dad?
That sounds good to me. No, in fact, I better ring them, see if she's all right, hadn't I?
No, don't be dad. The man wants to come home.
Oh, all right, then.
Hey, lads, fancy a drink?
Why is she blowing it out already?
No, I'm going to the bar to get Tara a drink.
Get in there!
You're a machine, mate.
Lucky guess.
You sure you want to go into this place?
Yeah, why?
Well, it's just you're not exactly dressed for it, are you?
Not exactly Brad Pitt, are you?
Sorry, I didn't mean to insult you.
It's all right. I'll let you off this once.
You really are an attractive girl, you know.
Tara. So, are we going into this club or what? I didn't come to sit in the car park all night.
Yeah, all right, come in.
Right then, come on. Ooh, get into bed and I'll read you a story.
Hold on.
Boo!
Oh! Nearly gave me an heart attack there, Kylie.
Bed, or I'll be having a word with Father Christmas.
See you in the morning, love.
Night-night. Oh, yeah, let me do that.
Oh, you're right, leave it, leave it. You don't have to do everything for me.
Oh, no. Sorry.
Jack, I just... for a few days, want to feel normal.
You are normal.
Kind of.
Hey, no, I'm not having that. Look at yourself. You're better. You're back to your old self, Jim. And don't let anyone try to tell you any different.
I'll never be back to my old self. I'm on medication. For the duration.
Yeah, and so is our Val for her blood pressure, but that doesn't mean to say she's not normal.
Oh, you might take the notice of me. Some visit this is going to be, isn't it, eh? All I'm going to do is whinge.
I will never give up on you, Jimmy Gorgo. Do you hear me? I love you too much.
Oh. Why?
God knows. But I do.
Hey. Suppose this is our chance to start again, eh? Hey, listen. Gonna make you glad you married me.
I already am.
No.
Right. You gotta come down.
Yeah, in a minute.
Okay.
Cheers, mate. We'll be packed in here, you know.
Is that going to be a problem?
Well, I thought we were going to talk business.
Well, we still can, can't we?
Look, I know plenty of places a little bit more intimate.
Well, we can do that next time. I'm just going to loo.
Where will I meet you?
Back here in about 2 minutes. I won't be long.
How are you feeling, Dad? Okay.
Yeah?
Brilliant to have you back home.
Feels weird.
In what way?
Well, I thought I'd come home and everything would be exactly as I left it.
Don't you like the wallpaper?
No, it's not that. It's just... oh, I don't know. A weird feeling. As if time hasn't stopped. You know, everyone's just been getting on with their lives as normal.
You have to, though, don't you?
Yeah. Doesn't exactly make me feel indispensable, though.
Dad. Linz, will you come sort the plates while I get on with this pudding? The Chinese will be here in a minute. Linz, what do you reckon? What about your dad, what do you think? I feel sorry for him. I think we've got to keep everything on an even keel, you know. No upset, no fighting, no arguments. Everything is normal.
Normal? How can you expect things to be normal now?
No, love, he's just got to get back on his feet. It'll take time.
I'm not talking about me, Dad.
What are you talking about?
You. Expecting us to play happy families.
We are a happy family.
Well, you could have fooled me.
Lynn's love, what's wrong? Are you all right? No. I'm far from all right, actually.
Oh, hang on, that'll be the Chinese.
I'll go.
Hello! Come in!
Who is it?
Hi. Shelley?
Hello, Jackie.
Look, I'm so sorry. I didn't realise that Jimmy was home.
Oh. What do you want?
Oh, I needed to see you.
I wondered when you'd turn up. We've just ordered something to eat.
Well, it won't take long.
Why don't you stay?
Oh, no, honestly, no.
Oh, why not? There's plenty, isn't there, Jack?
She said no.
Oh, don't be at it. She's just being polite.
Look, it's lovely of you to ask, but I don't really want to intrude.
Intrude? What are you on about? You're one of the family, kid.
I just wanted to see Lindsay.
Look, you're staying, and I'm not taking no for an answer. All right, come on, get your coat off.
Hey, what was Robbie like before?
It was all in for nothing.
He seems so loads of people.
Yeah, and then.
I have to pinch myself sometimes, you know. I can't believe it's actually working out. I mean, after I split up with Nathan, I didn't even think I'd look at anyone else. Never mind for madly in love.
You reckon you're in love with him?
Well, yeah, I suppose so.
You haven't known him that long now?
I've known him as long as you've known Clint. And to think, I nearly messed it all up lying about Harry.
Did he ever tell you why they got off to Spain?
No, they just went, didn't they?
Well, I don't know.
Well, as far as I know, I think it was just something to do.
That's what I thought, but...
Lippy?
No, Tom.
Sorry, go on. What were you saying?
Just about them getting off to Spain. And she reckons there was more to it.
In what way?
I don't know. She might just be trying to cause trouble because of Clint.
Cause trouble? Why? What's she been saying?
She reckons they had to go. She reckons they had to get out of Liverpool.
Why?
Because of Robbie.
Excuse me. Coming through. Dave Burns, is your backside glued to that stool?
I'm coming now.
You said that half an hour ago. What time do you call this?
Has he gone?
Of course he has. His plane's due in 5 minutes. Right, Dave, palm trees. Leanne, pineapples. Quiet Paul, you hand out the castanets. We have got 1 hour to turn this place into the Copacabana.
You all right?
Yeah, Sam.
Do you need a bevvy yet?
No, I'm fine.
What about a little pick-me-up?
How do you mean?
You know what I mean. Whiz.
Why, have you got any?
No, but I know a man who has.
Nah.
Don't want to sleep tonight, lad.
Don't I know it?
What's wrong?
Nothing.
You've only spoke to me all night.
As if you give a tosh.
Of course I do.
Yeah, yeah.
At least tell me what I've done.
It's more what you haven't done. It doesn't matter.
Steve, if you've got a problem, let's talk about it.
Look, there's no point.
In what?
Me and you.
Well, I think there is.
You've got a funny way of showing it.
What are you saying?
Look, me and you, we want different things.
And what's that supposed to mean?
Figure it out for yourself.
Listen, don't say anything.
Oh, Casey, I've got to say something.
You make him look like a right to me if it's not true.
Yeah, but he's not going to know it's you, is he?
I wish I hadn't said anything now.
Yeah, but it probably just wasn't. He's just trying to cause trouble.
He thought that himself, to be honest.
Yeah, we'll soon find out. I'll see you in a minute. See ya. Hiya.
Have you been?
I've been in the toilet. The queue's at a mile long.
Do you want a drink?
No, I'm all right for now. Listen, do you fancy a sit down? There's some seats over there.
Yeah, whatever.
I need to talk to you.
Have you seen that girl with Tim?
I know.
She's only just met him and look at her. She can't keep her hands off him.
I know, yeah.
I mean, you wouldn't do that on the first night, would you?
I don't know.
Oh, Katie, of course you and Clint.
I mean, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it. Do you want a spade to dig yourself a little bit deeper?
Oh, I didn't mean you to.
It's all right, Rach. I know, I'm a slut.
Reckon he'll give her one? If she's got anything to do with it, he will.
Hey, I thought he was going out with Nikki's sister.
Yeah, well, not anymore.
Bloody hell, doesn't waste much time, does he?
I didn't realise you were coming home. Lindsay didn't say.
I didn't know myself.
When did you get back, then?
About what, love? A couple of hours ago?
Yeah. Is that all? Oh. I'm so sorry.
Why?
Well, you don't want me in the way.
Don't be soft.
Look, if you just want a quiet evening in together, there's three of you.
You're staying? How many times do I have to tell you? Any friend of our Lindsay's is a friend of mine. And Jackie?
I'm so sorry, Lindsay. Not now. Please don't say anything to your mum.
I won't. Not when my dad's round. But don't think for one minute you've got away with it.
No, I am looking forward to that, Scran. Better than that flaming hospital food.
Is it that bad?
The chef's not as good looking as you.
You okay?
Yeah. A bit tired, that's all.
I wish you were home for good, Jim.
Well, it won't be long. Yeah, if this visit goes okay, do you reckon it'll just be, well, a matter of weeks?
Make it the best Christmas ever, eh?
Oh, yeah. No.
Do something. Show me it's not the end. Make the candles go out. Please. Please just give me a sign. Just show me somehow. Somewhere. You still exist.
Carl? Are you right?
Bloody hell.
Well then, what are you waiting for? So you did have a fight then?
Yeah.
But why didn't you just tell me?
Because there's nothing to tell. It was no big deal.
It's a big deal to me.
Why?
Because I don't like violence.
Oh, so now you think I go around beating people up every day?
Well, I don't know what you do I?
Look, Jack, I had a fight. Two lads had a go at me that night because they wanted to have a go at someone. What do you want me to do? Sit back and get a good eye?
Well, that's not what I'm saying.
Look, all I did was protect myself, like anybody else would. It doesn't make me a psychopath.
So why did you go off to Spain, then?
These lads were heavy. I got a bit scared.
Oh, you? Scared?
Yeah, I don't want to take any chances.
Is that Tim over there?
Where?
On the dance floor with a girl.
Well, I don't know. He was with somebody before.
What do you mean, with someone? Hiya. Why, Anish? What are you doing here? I was just about to ask you the same thing. On a Christmas night out, everyone's here.
Oh, I've just escaped a meal from hell. Work's night out.
So you're on your own?
No, I'm meant to be meeting a mate.
Oh, well, come sit with us, have a drink.
Oh, thanks.
You don't mind, do we, Jay? She following us or what?
Who?
Nisha.
Where?
Over there with Jerome and Nicky.
Oh, no, we've just got rid of her.
That's our night ruined. I won't have a word. Katie! You following us or what?
Sorry?
Can't we have a nice out without you hanging around like a bad smell?
I'm meeting a mate. I didn't know you were going to be here.
Oh, yeah.
I am. Why would I want to follow you?
I don't know. You tell me.
If you think I'd trail around town after Benny over there, you're sadder than I thought.
Nisha, just leave us alone, all right?
Gladly.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. What's going on? It's a long story. She thinks I'm after a boyfriend.
What, that Clint?
Exactly. I'm not that desperate.
Give a toss about how I feel, do you?
I do.
No, you don't. Everything I say, you do the opposite.
No, I don't.
See, you've just done it now.
No, I haven't. Give me an example.
OK, that car fella for the start.
He's a professional.
Professional lech.
He could be my big break.
You're throwing yourself at him. And for what? To get your knockers on page 3?
Do you really think I'm that stupid?
I've been taken in by him so far.
On his boots already, eh?
Who?
Romeo there. He's only just split up with Anna.
Well, if they're finished, they're finished. You can't expect him to stay celibate forever.
Well, he obviously doesn't give a toss about her.
Listen, like Nutnik, he's a 20-year-old lad.
Yeah, and what's that meant to mean?
He's got a lot on his mind.
He's out of order,
I think.
Don't you?
If she gives him the night of his life, that's what I'd want if I was going to prison in 12 hours' time. Anyone want a drink?
Where are you going now?
I'm looking for somewhere to sit.
The seat's over there.
Come on, let's go over there. It's not as packed.
Need a hand?
If I don't die waiting, what is it with female bar staff? Why do they only want to serve men?
So, do you come here often?
Is that a chat line?
As if.
Oh, not your type, eh?
Nisha, I was just trying to make conversation.
Jerome, chill. I'm winding you up. And no, I don't come here often. I usually go up the other end by Concert Square.
This is the first time I've been out in ages.
Oh, yeah.
It is.
You're a student, aren't you?
And
I live with a student and she's always out drinking.
I wish.
Are you serious?
Well, Nikki's always either knackered or got work or something or other.
Oh, poor Jerome.
I'm serious.
Well, if you ever want to go out, just give me a ring.
What?
I'll show you how to enjoy yourself. 2 pints of lager and an orange juice, please.
Look, you're making a big deal of nothing.
I know, I just wish you'd told me, that's all. I don't want to swap secrets from each other.
Oh, what, like the small matter of your son?
Oh, yeah, OK, so I've got double standards.
Yeah, and I've hardly committed the crime of the century, have I?
Oh, I know. All right, I shouldn't have made a big deal out of it.
Well, I'll let you off this time, just don't let it happen again.
Yeah, whatever you say, sir. What's up?
Just hang on a sec.
Where do you go?
I just need a quick word with Tim. Tim?
Yeah?
Lose the bimbo. Top of the stairs over there.
What's she doing here?
Sam, do you do this often?
What?
Take young girls, I believe I'm just...
Well, I do if they look interested in them.
And I do.
Well, he wouldn't be here if he didn't.
What's she playing at?
Hey, go easy, will you, Tim?
What's she doing with that meth?
Give me that money, he would.
She's trying to wind me up.
How did she know you were here?
Because I told her. She said she didn't want to come. Has she seen you?
She's looked over enough times. If he lays a finger on her, I'll kill him.
So I just get some photographs done, yeah?
Yeah, put together a portfolio.
All right. It sounds really professional.
Well, at least I've got something to hawk around.
Come here a minute. You've got something on your face. I think it's glitter off me.
Right, that's it.
Tim.
I'm gonna do it.
Tim, hang on.
Who do you think you are?
Tim! Come on, Bob.
Tim, get off him!
Stop it! No. Tim, get off! You're gonna kill him!
I'm gonna kill him!
What's
that divvy from Jay's 21st? Yeah, and I'll sort it.
Oh, Robbie, don't get involved.
Get off him! What are you trying to do? Come on, your senses!
Look, Tim, it's your last night. You're going to end up getting arrested.
Like you care! Somebody wants to put him on a lead. Are you going to leave him?
Yes.
Yeah?
Bloody lunatic. Do one. I'm not surprised he's going down. Do one now before I let him destroy you. Come on. I get the impression we're not welcome round here.
I'm staying here.
With the losers. Get in touch when he's inside. I'll show you a really good time.
What?
Leave it, Tim. It's not the right time. I'll be over by the other bar if you want me.
He's trying to wind me up.
You've got to pick your moment, mate. There's no one now. No point doing it now.
Get to the beach!
The sweat is pouring off me.
Oh, don't be so miserable. You look fantastic. You're like Clint Eastwood.
Oh, thanks.
Well, I don't know what's happened to Dave.
Where'd he go?
He's in the gents getting changed. Better check up on him.
wisecracks.
Dave, you ready?
There's no way I'm coming out dressed like this.
Oh, come on, let's have a nose.
I look ridiculous.
I'll be the judge of that.
Cowboys don't even come from Brazil.
You look fabulous.
I'm getting changed before anyone sees me.
No, you're not.
Let's have a look then.
Hey, what do you reckon?
Oh, I've seen it all now.
John Wayne is big leggy or what?
I can't believe how well you're looking, Jim.
It's only the last couple of weeks I've started feeling on my way back.
So do you think they've got your medication right?
Don't know. Reckon so.
I had a friend who suffered manic depression.
Oh.
Have you had many therapy sessions then?
Oh, yeah.
How did you find it?
Will you stop asking him questions?
Sorry, I was just interested, that's all.
Yeah, but he's trying to forget about it. Doesn't need reminding every 5 minutes.
All right, love. It's no big secret.
Oh, sorry, Jimmy. You don't have to talk about it if you don't want to.
I'm not bothered. You've got to accept people for what they are, haven't you? Hey? I mean, you're a lesbian. I'm a nut job. But, you know, we're harmless underneath, aren't we, eh? Once you get rid of the labels.
Well, everybody wears labels of some kind. Whether it be housewife, mother...
I'm not hiding anything. With me, what you see is what you get.
Yeah, but there must be times when you don't want to be Jackie Corkill, Hoover up a childminder.
Excuse me.
Where are you going?
I think I'm going to be sick.
Hey? Is she all right?
I'll go up. No, you won't. She's upset, you know.
What's going on?
Linz.
What do you want?
Are you all right?
Do I look all right?
I know you're upset, love, but can you not just come back down for your daddy? He's wondering what's going on down there.
I've come with that. I just need 5 more minutes.
Shelley will be going soon. She knows it's your dad's face nice at home. She won't be hanging around.
Shelley.
Look, I'll tell her to go now, if you like. I'm not having you upset like this.
You think I'm upset because of Shelley?
Well, you are, aren't you?
Think again, Mum.
I'm not with you.
I know.
Know what, love?
I know what's been going on between you.
What?
So you can stop playing your little act now, because it's public knowledge.
Hang on, Linz. I don't know what she said to you, but...
The only one in the dark about this is me dad. Or is that what you want? You know, so he doesn't have to go back into the loony bin.
The lying, spiteful little bitch.
That's what you want, isn't it? The house to yourself so you can move your girlfriend in.
Girlfriend?
My own mother.
Lindsay.
You disgust me.
Just to let you know, Jackie's spoken to Robbie and he's told what happened.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he has. So you can keep your lies to yourself in future.
It wasn't a lie.
What is it with you? Why are you always trying to cause trouble?
I'm not.
Every time I mention the name Moffat, you've got something to say.
Look, Katie, I don't want to argue with you because we've got to work together.
Yeah, unfortunately.
It's not you I can't stand. It's Robbie and Clint.
Look, just forget about him and move on.
I don't fancy him.
Yeah.
Look, Katie, I've had the Clint Moffat experience, remember? If he was the last one on earth, I'd still turn him down.
You're obsessed.
Katie, don't say I didn't warn you. Are you jealous, is that it?
No.
Then why is it such a big deal?
Put yourself in my shoes. Your girlfriend will strip down to her undies for some sleazy photographer with a hard on, but I'm not allowed to touch.
Who says?
Let's face it, team, we're not exactly a couple, are we? I mean, I can hold your hand, but I'm pretty far from a home run.
You said we'll take things slowly.
Yeah, well, I never thought we'd never get out of first gear.
By
Thanks, Steve. Thanks for being so understanding.
We might as well just be mates.
So what are you saying, that you want us to finish?
Yeah, if that's what you want. Look out for your pictures in some glossy mag.
Fine.
Great.
See ya.
Bye.
She's making a big mistake.
So you keep saying.
Yeah, well, she's 17 years of age. She should be out having a good time. Not training up to want to visit a deadbeat boyfriend every week.
You're all heart, you.
Yeah, well, she's my sister, the only one I've got. I'm not going to sit back and let her make a mess of her life, am I?
I did it because I wanted to make you jealous.
Oh, that's all right, then.
You said we were finished.
You know why I said that?
Look, I wanted to make sure that you still love me. I did it because I was desperate.
Of course I still love you.
Do you?
You're all I've got. What do you think?
I've missed you so much. I haven't been able to eat. I haven't been able to sleep.
It hasn't been a nightmare for me. You've only been living next door and I haven't been able to see you.
I knew you didn't mean it when you said we were finished.
I thought it was for your own good.
I'm nothing without you. You took the rap for me. I'll never forget that.
That was because I love you.
That's ain't cause. When he had to say it was all your fault. I felt like dirt.
I couldn't see you go to prison, Em. I love you too much for that.
Yeah. And now you're going down and it's all because of me.
We've been through all this.
Are you scared?
Honestly?
Honestly?
Yeah. I'm all right now. Anytime I'm feeling low, I'll just think of you. And it's all right.
I love you, Tim.
I love you, Em.
What am I going to do when you go to prison?
I don't believe this.
Nikki, it's none of our business.
Aye, aye. Here comes trouble.
Leave it, will you?
Excuse me, who's a slapper?
Who are you calling a slapper, you cheeky cow? That's my fella.
Why don't you ask Tim, Em? He was all over here like a rash 5 minutes ago.
Is that true?
No, I haven't done anything.
Not much you haven't.
You've been with someone else.
No, I was only talking to her.
Talking to her? You had your tongue down the back of the girl's throat.
While I was at home crying my eyes out.
Look, she came on to me.
You cheeky get. Tell you what, everything that you just said to me was a pack of lies, and I was ready to believe it.
Emily, where you going?
To find Carl.
What's going on?
My girlfriend sticking the oar in again, as usual.
Look, I take it all back, you're the star.
Yeah, Tim just wasn't thinking straight, that's all.
Hey, God knows what would have happened if you hadn't stepped in there.
Yeah, but it's over and done with now, isn't it?
Oh, there's Rachel, so there won't be a sec, just gotta give her this.
Niche, here a minute.
What?
I believe you've been telling Porky's about me to Jackie.
No.
Yeah, well, a little dicky bear tells me you have. Bit of advice, keep your nose out of other people's business. I'd hate to see you getting into any trouble.
Aw, thanks. I'll remember that. She's my sister. I was looking after me own.
Well, have you ever stopped to consider that Tim and Emily are in love? And no matter what you or any of your family do, nothing's going to keep them apart.
It's a good job Tim's going to prison then, isn't he?
Now, this little piece of paper can change your life, so look after it, all right?
Carl, I've been looking for you everywhere.
Oh, aye, what happened to Bruce Willis?
Like you said, it's not with the hassle, is he? So when are you going to introduce me?
Actually, they were just getting off, weren't you, girls?
Who were we?
Hey, you got my card. Give us a ring.
All right. Thank you.
Bye. Bye. I'll have vodka and lemonade, please.
Now, do you want to go somewhere else?
No. Why should we leave because of him?
You nasty cow.
Thought we agreed, Tim. You two can't be together.
I can't cope. I love her.
You're going to jail tomorrow. You're bad news.
But I can't get it out of my head.
You're going to have to. It's after tonight. I don't think she'll be in any mood to visit yet, do you?
I'm sorry. If I'd known he was going to be here, I wouldn't have said to have come.
He's an animal. He deserves to be locked up.
He can't get his head around the fact that we're finished. He's really jealous.
And what about you?
What about me?
Well, when your modelling career takes off, you don't want to be involved with a loser like that.
I won't. It's over.
Good. Someone like him will just hold you back.
Hat's on the house. Aww, why don't you put your hat on?
Don't, Bev. I feel stupid enough as it is.
Is that a pistol in your pocket?
Oh, you're just pleased to see me.
Watch it, it's loaded.
Oh, then why don't you shoot it?
Do you mind? You're knocking me sick.
Well, I've got to keep myself occupied somehow. Where's Lance? He should have been here ages ago.
I was just thinking that.
Yeah, well, if you don't get here soon, I'm going to kick off. Those pineapples cost a bomb.
Well, you better get here soon, otherwise I am going to melt.
Maybe we could get changed, call it a night.
No way. Hey, Dave, pass us my maracas. Let's have a little dance.
Don't even think about it.
Oh, come on.
Look, if you want to dance, why don't you ask the man with no name?
Because the man with no name has got two little words for it, and the second one is off.
Well, someone's got to get the party going. No one's dancing.
Well, that's because they came for a drink, not a South American nightmare.
Oh, well, I'm sorry, but I've had enough of standing here contemplating my navel. I feel a salsa coming on.
Hey, you getting off?
Come on, Twinkle Toes. Let's show them how it's done.
What was the point? What was the point if you're not somewhere around me with Matthew and Emily in your arms? What was the point of you existing at all? Susanna, if this is it, this is the end. And I can't go on.
If I'd have known your dad was
here. What'd you come round here for?
Not to stop you from saying anything to your mum.
It's too late.
Gathered that.
Don't come round again, because I've got nothing to say to you anymore, right?
Don't be. I'm worried about you.
Worried about me? You don't give a crap about me.
Well, of course I do.
Then what'd you do it for? Tell me, Shelley, why did you do it?
Couldn't be me.
As I've said, I never wanted to hurt you.
Oh, that's
just. Don't be too hard on her, okay?
Oh. So, Shelley, what's going down in your neck of the woods? You caught?
No, not at the moment.
Go away. Find that hard to believe. Good-looking girl like you. Bet they're like flies round.
Jimmy, that's enough.
What?
Leave her alone, will you?
Why? I'd be interested to know Shelley's bedding. Who are you with at the moment, Shell? Or do you just sleep round, you know, go with loads of different women at the same time?
Lindsay, not now.
Hang on, I was only asking if she was caught. Don't want to know the ins and outs of everything.
Look, like I said, I'm not seeing anyone at the moment, OK? And on that note, I better go. It's late. Thanks for the food, Jackie. I really enjoyed it.
Oh, she'll do your fish supper next time.
Bye, Jimmy.
Oh.
It's good to see you home looking so well.
Oh, well, it's good to be here. Yeah, hey, you take care of yourself, kid.
I'll see you out.
No, it's all right, Lindsay. Keep your dad company. I'll take care of our guest.
Jackie, please, just let me explain.
Vicious, spiteful bitch.
You don't understand.
Oh, I understand, all right. You couldn't just leave it. You couldn't keep your big trap shut.
It wasn't like that.
I am sick of listening to you and your lies. Well, you're going to listen to me this time. You told Lindsay.
No, I haven't.
I told you to shut it. You told Lindsay. Next thing you could be telling Jimmy, I'm going to tell you this. You come near me or my family again, and I'll kill you.
Thank you.
So, anyway, I just told you, Jack.
Did you?
I said you leave Clint and Robbie Moffat alone, because they're top lads, aren't they?
Yeah.
So don't you worry, she won't be causing any more trouble. I feel sick.
Casey, how many have you asked?
I'm fine, I'm fine. Oh, do you know what, Jack? You're my best mate in the whole world.
I know.
I love you.
I know.
How have we been mates?
Years.
Years, and we are like that, aren't we? Oh, I feel really terrible.
Casey, I think you need some water. Come on. He said it because I won't sleep with him.
That old chestnut.
He said he wants to finish it.
Well, Jean, he's not worth crying over.
That's it, Nick. He is. He's really nice.
He shouldn't be putting pressure on you, then.
He hasn't. He's been really understanding. I think I've just pushed things too far. Every time we've talked about sex, I've mentioned Jason. Must be really doing Steve's head in.
Oh, come on, that one's. Aren't you tired, Dad? You've had a big day.
Hey, you don't know how happy I am just sitting here with the two people that matter the most to me.
You don't know how glad I am to have you back.
I haven't half been lonely, you know. And I don't just mean in the hospital, I mean up here in my head. It's like I'm close to people. But really, I'm a million miles away from them. Truth is, I've been like that for years. You two have supported me. And I've been living in my own little world, giving nothing back. Hey, come here, the two of you, come on. Come on, I'm not saying no for an answer. Ah, oh, that's it. I've got everything I could ever want right here. My family.
I know what you'd say if you were here now. So don't be so ridiculous. Pull yourself together. Do it for the sake of the children. That's what you'd do if you were here, but you are strong.
You want to go now?
Katie's been sick in toilets.
I'll just get me cold then.
No, you stay out.
That's it.
Mike, why should you have to go home just because I want to?
Oh, I feel terrible, that's why.
Bothered,
look, Rach, it's not fair, is it?
Mike, stay out and have a drink with the lads. Honestly, I don't mind.
You sure?
Positive.
Do you know what, Rach? I don't deserve you.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
Come here, kiss.
Get lost, you stinking prick. See you later. Have
nice
a good
one,
night.
Rach.
Katrina and Steve are finished. Oh, look, she's dead upset.
Oh, come off it, Nick. Stay out.
It's all right, Nick. You don't have to come with me.
Shut up, you. I want to come.
Oh, surprise, surprise.
Yeah, well, I'm worried sick about Aunt Emily.
You're worried about everyone, aren't you? Except for me.
Yeah, well, I just don't want to go home on her own.
Well, you know, if you hadn't stuck your nose in before, she'd have still been with Tim.
Yeah, well, she isn't, so you can go round and have a look for her for me.
I think Emily can look after herself.
Right, fine. Come on, Katrina. Thanks a lot, Jake. See you back at Mix.
Steve, are you going?
Yeah.
Look, about before.
It doesn't matter.
I wanted to apologise.
See ya.
I'm sorry, Steve. See ya. What's going on? Where's everybody gone?
We've got off.
Oh, are you joking? You're not going, are you?
No.
Oh, thank God, my mate still hasn't arrived.
Don't worry about it. I'll get us a drink.
Oh. My eyes are closing here. I think I'll go up.
Get a good night's sleep and you'll feel better in the morning.
Don't forget to switch everything off when you come up, eh?
Okay.
Good night, Linz. See you tomorrow.
Night, Dad. I think you've got some explaining to do.
Don't speak to me like that. You look, I'm speaking to you at all.
I'm your mother. You should respect us.
Respect you? I can hardly bear to look at you.
Shelley's told you a pack of lies?
Yeah, well, you would say that, wouldn't you?
I'm going to say this to you once more, and then never again. Nothing happened.
Mother, you slept with my girlfriend.
I am not a lesbian.
I don't believe this.
What?
Our Wills. He's awake. I can't settle him.
Come up and see Jim now.
Must be because I've been away so long. He's forgotten what I look like.
You're not going to leave me to clear the mess up on my own, are you?
Oh, you don't mind, love. Your mother looks done in.
Of course not, no. Good night, Dad.
See you in the morning, love.
Good night, Lindsay.
Yeah, good night, Mum. I'll see you in the morning, too.
If life is just extinguished and ends just like that, I don't care. Nothing is better than the torment that I'm living now.
So how come you get to stay out there, mate?
How do you mean?
Well, I thought you were under the thumb. So your missus finally let her guard down.
I'll stay out as long as I want. It's got nothing to do with it.
So why did Nikki get off?
She had to take a mate home.
So she's left you all on your lonesome?
Yeah, well, everyone takes priority over me.
Are you feeling sorry for yourself?
As if.
So is it a long-term relationship?
Yeah.
Married job?
I don't think so.
She seems like a really nice girl.
Yeah, she is. She's dead nice.
Just like to be tucked in bed before midnight, eh?
Tomorrow, eh?
Yeah.
Best place for him. What's he going down for?
A couple of things, really. Burglary. Having cars. Do you mind if we get off in a minute?
Yeah, whatever.
I'm not going to just sing.
I just want to have a word with a few people downstairs.
What's that Divvy doing?
Who?
Him. He's just thrown a bottle. I think the bouncers are coming over.
Where is he? I can't see no one.
In there, in the middle.
Hang on, that's Tim.
One for Sinbad. One for our Ben.
Is it?
One for me mum.
Leave him, will you?
Yeah,
he's with me. No. Look, I know he's out of order, but he's going down tomorrow.
Oh! This is madness.
Come on, you Clara Killjoy, join in.
Not on your life.
Some of us have got reputations to consider.
We are, mate.
I'd be having an own bounce, you'd be dead by now.
Come on!
This is soft.
Oh, there's no way we're going to get picked up here.
I'm not even stopping.
For God's sake!
Come on, we might as well start walking, see if we can get one on the way.
I'm not walking anywhere, right?
Well, this cage,
I'm going home in style. See you in a minute.
Hey, don't.
Just wait here, will you?
Oh, I'm freezing.
Do you want to borrow my coat?
Oh, thanks.
The car's parked around the back. Do you want to wait inside while I go and get it? Emily!
Here we go. Hiya!
Yeah, hang on, I won't be a second. How are you getting on?
I'm flying on a magic carpet, how do you think?
I take you going with him.
Yeah. Why? What's it got to do with you?
Let's just put it this way. You can do much better.
I'm going to get the car. I'll see you back here in a minute.
Okay.
Have you got any idea what you're doing to Tim?
David is a killjoy. Leanne is one too.
Oi!
She's lost the plot.
Shut her up, will ya?
How?
I don't know. Gag her.
Hey, quiet, Paul. Get rid of that tray. Get it on the table.
What? No way.
That's something worth watching.
Bananas. Told you you're out your depth.
Jerome, is Tim with you?
Yeah.
Then where's he gone?
I don't know.
Look, has he took that girl home?
No.
You don't have to lie to me, you know.
Emily, I'm not lying to you. He was there a minute ago, I swear.
See you later.
Where are you going?
To find Carl.
You still drinking?
I need to go home, though.
Your ex will be at the front door with a rolling pin, won't she?
What time are you up in the morning?
Half six.
Half six? It's only 4 hours away.
Has Emily got off?
What do you think?
Is she on with that fella then?
You know, I don't know. Where have you been?
For a slash. What's happening? Any taxis been passed?
Only 4 ones.
Do you know what? I'm going to walk.
Walk?
I only live off Princess Avenue. I'll get a curry on the way home.
I'm starving.
Well, why don't you come with me? Or will Nicky be expecting you back?
No, Nicky won't mind. Does anybody else fancy a curry?
No.
Hey.
Nah.
Well, I'll catch you later then, lads.
Come, Ed, we might as well try and get a cab along the road.
Right, lads, taxi for 4 sad buttes.
Tim, I love you.
Where'd you get it from? I found it. Come here, get in.
I'm not getting in there. Why not?
Look at him, he's off his head. No way I'll walk.
Well, if you want to freeze your balls off walking 6 miles, lads.
It doesn't bother me. Can you come with Mike?
No, that's all right, I'll just get in here.
Mike, he's off his head.
Come on, he's coming or what? Come on, kid, get in, he's bottled it.
Mike, please come on with me. Mike, he's on one.
Emily. Emily, it's me.
Carl? What happened?
Somebody jumped me.
I'll phone an ambulance.
Was that Tim?
No.
It must have been.
Aya, can I have an ambulance, please? Somebody's been beaten up. He's in a bad way.
Good night, everyone. Come again.
Yep,
should be
the cowboy after the door.
That's it. Lovely. Want a snatchers? Oh, way. I'm sorry about that sangria stain. If you send me the dry cleaning bill, I'll have it sorted, OK? Good night. Hey, aren't you forgetting something? Klepto. Good night. Oh, there's always one, isn't there, eh? See ya. Oh, what a night. Was that fantastic? Or was that fantastic?
And the person it was in aid of didn't even turn up.
Oh, lads. Completely forgot about him. Wonder what happened.
Probably gone to town.
Why didn't I think of that?
Yeah, they've probably gone to a club, haven't they? Oh, well, we had a laugh, didn't we?
Did we?
I'll get the lights.
Probably not going to turn up now.
Now in our lands. He's probably snogging the chops off me in Garland's by now.
Well, you don't know what they've missed, do they, hey? Come on, sunshine. Let's go home and play cowboys and Indians.
Look, it's Lance and Fred.
When is he? Let's see.
Where's Fred?
I don't know.
What?
I've been sitting there for hours checking every plane. He didn't turn up. Oh.
This flat is top.
It's all right.
So did you do it yourself?
Yeah. I thought mate couldn't paint her own toenails.
So have you lived together long, like?
Not that long.
Where is she?
Good question. Anyway, what about you? How long have you been living with Nikki?
I don't know. Well over a year, though.
Yeah?
So, have you seen anyone?
Oh, no, I've given up on all that love and marriage stuff since I finished with Clint.
Right.
Not that I'm celibate or anything.
Not that I said you was or anything.
Do you want another lager?
I think maybe I should phone a taxi. It's getting late.
Oh, do you have to rush off?
No, it's just, it's past two and I'll never get home.
You could always stay.
Stay?
I mean, I don't mind.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. It's up to you.
Unless you really, really have to go.
No. No, I haven't.
Unless anyone fancies 2 a.m. coffee.
Oh, no, thanks. Oh, listen, well, happy Christmas anyway.
Yes, yeah, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
See you, Trot.
See you. Bye,
Katie.
Merry Christmas.
Some water.
Where are you going?
This way.
See you.
Oh, how are you feeling, Katie?
Oh, I feel terrible. I must have eaten something dodgy.
Like 15 Bacardis. What's going on in there?
Like Max is having a late night.
What, do you think I should knock and make sure everything's okay?
No, what are you worried about?
What, I don't know. What if he's fallen asleep and he's left them candles burning?
Jackie, I'm gonna have to go. Max burns the house down, that's up to him.
I'll only be a minute. Oh.
Jackie, where are you going? Katie, come on. Come on.
Ow. See you tomorrow, I'm going to bed.
Oh, late, I'm got upset.
Oh. Oh, I think I'm gonna be sick again. Oh.
Thank you.
Max?
No, just leave me. Please.
Thanks, mate. Merry Christmas.
Steve? Steve?
All right.
I'm waiting for you to come back.
Oh, why?
I'm sorry for being such a cow tonight.
Don't be soft, look. It was my fault I was well out of order.
What you said about me and you.
Just forget I opened my big mouth.
You're right. We don't, you know, do we? And we could. I fancy it like mad.
Do you?
Yes, I do.
I fancy you like mad, you know that, don't you?
Come on.
Where are we going?
We'll see.
Slow down.
Cody's bottle's gone.
No, I'm conscious.
Here we go. Yes!
Dibby.
Shall I put my foot down?
Go on, lad. Okay.
I haven't got anything.
I'm fully prepared.
Ooh, Katrina Evans, you scarlet woman.
Clint?
What happened?
Take a wild guess. Tim?
Mike?
Tim, get out the car now!
Oh no, oh my God, Mike!
Tim, get out the car!
What about Mike? We'll have to phone an ambulance, look at him!
Just go before the busies get here, you know, before the magistrates in the morning!
What about Mike?
Just get out now! What are you doing?
I'm phoning an ambulance.
Putting a finger on us, you divvy.
What are you on about?
He'll chase the call. I'm not getting done for no Rob Carr.
We can't just leave him.
You'll find the phone box on the way.
Hang on. What if it's too late? He's in a bad way.
Yeah, well, I'm not taking any chances.
Robbie!
Come on, the bitches will be here any minute.
Shh. Come on. Sleepy time now, isn't it? Come on. Oh. Your daddy will be home soon, won't he, eh? Your lovely daddy. And then we're going to have the best Christmas ever. Yeah, we are. Come on.
You saved my life.
I just want you to know you've got the wrong idea about all this Shelley nonsense.
So you didn't stay the night with her?
Onde está Frederico?
Oh, my God, he speaks Brazilian.
Rachel, Mike,
there's been a car crash.
Brookside's back tomorrow on 4 at 8 o'clock.